concessions and local restaurants, or you can pledge an amount per Goldeyes strikeout in the Fillmore Riley K's for Kids program. Learn more at goldeyes.com. Thanks to you, the Field of Dreams Foundation continues to make kids' dreams come true.
The Winnipeg Goldeyes make dreams come true by providing live baseball experiences to charities, nonprofit groups, and inner-city programs. Now, with the Goldeyes Community Zone, even more memories are available to be made. For group tickets, contact the Goldeyes at 982-BASE. These extra seats are only possible through generous donations from the Community Zone partners. So, from the Winnipeg Goldeyes and Community Zone recipients, thank you. Rona Home and Garden, Investors Group, and Manitoba Lotteries Corporation.
Now, back to the pregame show with the voice of the Goldeyes, Paul Edmonds.
Now, the morning line brought to you by Assiniboia Downs. Exciting horse racing, gaming, and dining open all day, every day. Go to asdowns.com for more information. Assiniboia Downs, Feel the Rush. Goldeyes are 38-27 coming into this one. Sioux Falls 29-36. They've lost six in a row. This is game 66. We'll watch the games tonight involving... Wild teams chasing the Goldeyes for the wild card or involved in the Goldeyes division. And that's Sioux Falls here in Winnipeg for sure. Fargo at Gary at 6:10 tonight as the Goldeyes are four games back of Fargo for first in the north. And also we'll watch St. Paul hosting Quebec tonight. Quebec, well, they're looking for their fourth win in five starts on this west swing, if you will. And St. Paul, 3-0 back at the Goldeyes in the wild card standings. And Kansas City hosting Grand Prairie tonight. Kansas City, 3 back at the Goldeyes for first in the wild card standings as well. All right, we'll take another timeout. When we come back, we'll have a look at the pitching matchup. On the rubber for Cal Tire, next after these on TSN 1290.
This Goldeyes season, Salisbury House on the Esplanade Real is hitting it right out of the park. With great new taste sensations to get you ready to roar before the game or relive the fun after the final out. With so many great choices, every visit is a new eating adventure. And remember, Sal's is the only place to go for a nip platter, the fan favorite that hits a home run every time. So before or after any Goldeyes game, stroll on over for great food and fun on the Esplanade Real at Salisbury House. Your house, your food, your way.
Luxury, convenience, comfort. Have it all with Premier Executive Suites. For business travelers who are always on the move, Premier Executive Suites is your home away from home. You can relax in your comfortable living room, grab a midnight snack in your complete kitchen, and do that last-minute load of laundry with your handy in-suite washer and dryer. Book your extended stay in Winnipeg with Premier Executive Suites. Visit PremierSuites.com to make your booking today. Take more of your life with you with Premier Executive Suites.
While there's no known cure for ALS, there is hope. The ALS Society of Manitoba supports families affected by ALS. Our client services coordinator works with your family to determine your needs. And the Brummett-Feasby ALS House provides 24-hour care designed to specifically meet the needs of people living with ALS. Because hope is important in the lives of those affected by ALS. The ALS Society of Manitoba. We help our people every way we can. Visit ALSMB.ca.
Discover la francophonie in Manitoba.
La Broquerie, Île-des-Chênes, Sainte-Rose-du-Lac, Notre-Dame-de-Lourdes, Saint-Pierre-Joly, Saint-Boniface, and way much more.
In our friendly province, we are fortunate. French is everywhere and has lots to offer. Open your mind, add a French twist to your life, and enjoy the richness of another beautiful culture right here in Manitoba.
Venez voir. Venez voir. Vous serez surpris. Surpris. Venez voir.
Now, let's get back to the Goldeyes pregame show with Paul Edmonds.
Real quick, on the rubber, brought to you by Cal Tire, five convenient locations in the capital region. We're more than just tires. Cal Tire, true service. Rich Hawkins, a left-hander, gets the start for the Goldeyes here tonight, 3-1 with a 6.15 ERA. Alan Durratt, a right-hander, counters for Sioux Falls, 3-5 and a 5.43 earned run average. Goldeyes win here tonight. They win the series, have a chance for the sweep. If they lose, well, they'll fight the rubber match with Sioux Falls tomorrow afternoon. We'll see what happens. That's it for the pregame show right at the ballpark for Winnipeg Insurance. Pause for the other anthem when we come back. Starting lineup's first pitch, Goldeyes, Pheasants, TSN 1290.
Yep!
There's lots of storage reality stuff on TV these days, but in Winnipeg, real people prefer real storage at Storageville. Why? Two super convenient locations, both with really easy access to your locker. It's absolutely secure and always pristine clean. Learn more about Storageville's many wow factors at storageville.ca and sign up for upcoming auction alerts. Never know what treasures you might find. Storageville, where Winnipeg stores.
Yep!
For 5 years, the new Pembina Chrysler has become Winnipeg's most conveniently located automotive center. From a 30-minute Ords-free oil change, All-Make Collision Center, Canada's largest parts volume dealer, or an incredible selection of new and used vehicles, it's really all here at the new Pembina Chrysler. So why drive to the outskirts of the city to buy, much less go all the way back for service, when it's all here at the new Pembina Chrysler Dodge Jeep, 300 Pembina Highway or PembinaChrysler.com.
Hit a home run this summer at any of RB's six Winnipeg locations. Whether you want to lead off with RB's oven roasted roast beef or return for a designated hit with a market fresh sandwich or wrap, you'll always come away feeling like a winner after a visit to RB's. What are you thinking? I'm thinking RB's. Locally owned and operated and proud to be a corporate sponsor of your Winnipeg Goldeyes.
The pros at Tradesman Mechanical Services are good people to know when life throws you a screwball that screws up your home's comfort zone. They're experts, so they can install and service all the latest York heating and air conditioning products. Tradesman Mechanical has a 24-hour service desk, so when trouble strikes, call anytime. They service all makes and models because your comfort is their business. Tradesman Mechanical Services. They can help your home run better.
You've got the best seat in the house, your house, with live Goldeyes coverage you can take anywhere, only on TSN 1290. Now, back to the voice of the Goldeyes, Paul Edmonds.
Rich Hawkins gets the start for the Goldeyes. Starting lineup brought to you by Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries, 1425 Ellis. Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries, live life comfortably. The left-hander from the great state of Oklahoma will get the start for the Goldeyes as they win last night in game one of this series, 2-1. They're wearing white tops, white pants. Sioux Falls in a black top, gray pant, and orange sleeves from the shoulder to the elbow. Johnny Kaplan will lead it off for Steve Shirley and the Pheasants. He's in center field. Corey Morales bats second. He's at short. Jared Bolden out in left hitting third. Cesar Nicolas batting cleanup and playing third base. Trevor Lawhorn is at first hitting sixth. Jake Taylor will DH and bat seventh. And the bottom three will be Rich Carpenter out in right. Al Quintana will catch and hit eighth. And Joe Anthonson will bat ninth and play at second base. That lineup again is Kaplan, Morales, Bolden, Nicolas, Lawhorn, Taylor, Carpenter, Quintana, and Anthonson. And Sioux Falls 29-36 coming in, six straight losses. And Christian Guerrero will not play tonight. He was replaced by Jake Taylor as the DH last night after having one at bat, scoring a run, and just realizing that he's got a quad problem that is going to keep him out for a little while again. It was suffered originally last weekend when these teams hooked up in South Dakota. So here we go, and glad to have you along. Rich Hawkins, the lefty, will look in. He's 3-1 of the year, and Johnny Kaplan will stand in from the right side. And home plate umpire Mike Rigger says play ball, and here comes the first pitch. And it swung on and chopped left side foul at 6:06 tonight. So strike one at 6 minutes after 6 o'clock Central. Tonight's opening pitch brought to you by the Greenwood Inn & Suites. Make the Greenwood Inn & Suites your home base for all your accommodation, dining, and meeting needs in Winnipeg. Call toll-free today, 888-233-6730. Opening pitch at 6:06 Central tonight. And the 0-1 pitch is just outside. One ball, one strike. Johnny Kaplan, 0-4 last night, struck out once. And here comes the 1-1. Swing and a miss and a change of pace, and it's 1-2. Good pitch from Rich Hawkins. Our home plate umpire tonight is Mike Riggers. He calls the balls and strikes. Mike O'Leary is over at first, and Joe Stegner is at third. And we'll have those gentlemen again for tomorrow. 1-2, Curve swung on, hit on the ground, out to short. Up with it, Duran. Over to first. One away. And Corey Morales, the batter. So Ringer's calling the balls and strikes. O'Leary at first, Stigner at third. They'll rotate around again for tomorrow's finale of this six-game homestand. This is game five tonight. Goldeyes are 1-3 on the homestand so far. And the record at home, 18-14. The record away, 20-13. Here's Morales, a right-handed batter, first pitch. Fastball right down the chute for a strike. Defensively for the Goldeyes tonight, Luis Alen, after getting the day off from catching yesterday, he played first base, but he caught 22 straight games, the 0-1. Swung on a change of pace and fouled away down the right field line on a play, strike two. Catches again here tonight. Trendle DeCaster, DH last night. He's back at first tonight. Bryce Kendall at second. Jose Duran at short. Amos Ramon is at third base. The 0-2 pitch to Morales. Fastball low, one ball and two strikes. Then Kyle Day, who caught last night, is out and left today. Jon Weber is DHing for the Goldeyes tonight. Chris Roberson in center and Josh Mazzola out and right. The 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss and a breaking ball, and Morales down on strikes. Strikeout number one tonight for Rich Hawkins. And there's two away, and that first strikeout by Hawkins brought to you by Manitoba Hydro. Manitoba Hydro reminds you to be safe around electricity. Folks, one strike, and you're out. Here's left-handed swinging left fielder Jared Bolden. Some shiny-looking shoes. Well, they're Nike shoes, and they're black, and they've got a little bit of silver on them. I would say they're Vogue. First pitch, change up in there for a strike. Good pitch. Bolden 0 for 4 last night. He struck out once. In fact, there was a lot of offers last night for Sioux Falls. They managed just three hits. The 0-1. Breaking ball swung on and fouled back. And it's nothing at 2. The Goldeyes, by comparison, had 10. Jared Bolden batting .315. Six homers, 39 driven in. And Rich Hawkins will look in and get the sign from Luis Alen. The 0-2. Breaking ball swung on and missed. It was dropped by Alen. Now he'll pick it up. Step into throwing lane. Fire to first to complete the putout. And that is it for Sioux Falls here in the top of the first to open up the baseball game. Second strikeout for Rich Hawkins. Zeros across the board for Sioux Falls. They come away empty. The Goldeyes are coming to bat when we return to downtown on TSN 1290.
And here's a picture of Andy at the beach.
You mean that tiny speck on the horizon?
Yeah. Oh, you know, here's a better picture. He's the yellow blurry thing in the middle.
Don't be stuck with a camera you don't know how to use. Shop Don's Photo. They have that same camera you found at the box store, even the same price. The difference is, they'll actually show you how to use it. Visit donsphoto.com or stop by one of our three Winnipeg stores and let's talk photography.
Support your own. The Goldeyes and Fort Garry Brewing. Located right here in Winnipeg, Fort Garry Brewing is Manitoba's number one brewery, crafting a full spectrum of delicious beers and ales, including the award-winning Fort Garry Dark and fan favorite Fort Garry Pale, both of which are available at Shaw Park. So cheer on the home team. Fort Garry Brewing, Manitoba made, Manitoba's own.
Welcome back. How was the vacation?
It was fine. Why is everything so different in here?
We upgraded all our office equipment to new technology from Rico through Milne Office Systems.
How much more is this costing us?
After Milne did a document needs analysis, they showed us how we could increase our productivity and decrease our costs.
So where's my new copier?
It's not a copier. It's a Rico.
Visit MilneOffice.com to arrange for your own customized Rico digital workflow solution today.
Bottom of the first inning, we welcome you back. Our operator back at our studios in South Winnipeg is Rob Innes. Dana Robbie helping us out on site, super student. And my name is Paul Edmonds. Sioux Falls goes 1-2-3, top of the first, and Goldeyes will lead it off with last night's hero, or one of them, in Bryce Kendall, got the punt down. on a squeeze play in the bottom of the ninth to score Amos Ramon, and this place went crazy last night. So it's Kendall, Roberson, and Weber to face Alan Durratt, the right-hander. First pitch is right down the middle for a strike. Kendall 1-for-5 last night with that RBI that came in the bottom of nine. The 0-1 is in there for a strike, nothing in two. The bunt couldn't have been placed any better. It was on the grass between the mound and third. Amos broke for home. That was all she wrote. Pitches swung on, bounced left side, foul. And it's still nothing in two to Kendall. Kendall drove in his 26th run batted into the year last night with that squeeze bunt. The 0-2 pitch. Curve swung on, fouled to the plate. And we do it again. So Kendall, Roberson, Weber, and Weber DHing tonight. DeCaster, Allen, and Day. Then Mazzola, Ramon, and Duran. The fastball is swung on and lined over first down the right field line. Over to pick it up in foul territory is Carpenter. He'll fire it back in, but Kendall gets an 0-2 knock the other way. And here is Chris Roberson. So second hit in the series for Price. And he leads off with a single here tonight. And Chris Roberson, the batter, riding an 11-game hitting streak into this one. Hitting .328. Second on the team in average behind DeCaster. The pitch is in there for a strike. Alan Durratt, 6'5", 210 pounds of right-hander from Asheville, North Carolina. And Allen, 26 years old. Time called, and backing out of the left side batter's box is Roberson. Defensively tonight, for Sioux Falls, Al Quintana is the other half of the battery, doing the catching. The 0-1 changeup is a little bit high, one ball, one strike. Trevor Lawhorn over there holding on Price Kendall at first base. Joe Anthonson at second, Corey Morales at short, Cesar Nicolas is at third. From the stretch, the 1-1 is in there for a strike, off speed again, 1-2 to Roberson. Then Jared Bolden, Johnny Kaplan, and Rich Carpenter left to right in the field for Steve Shirley and the Pheasants tonight. Roberson, 9 home runs to lead the team. The 1-2 is just outside, 2-2. And he's driven in 47. That ties him with Sherendel DeCaster for the team lead in RBI. Kendall over there at first, 15 of 18 in the base paths. The 2-2, runner on the move, pitch is swung on and lined right back up the middle, off the pitcher and through the box for a base hit. Oh, baby, a comebacker that Durratt, I think, just got the glove up to protect himself, and it ricocheted off the glove by Anthonson at second and back through the middle for a base hit. A rocket off the bat of Roberson. And runners on the corners here as Kendall goes first to third on that. And the batter is Jon Weber. Boy, that's a scary situation, the scariest for a pitcher. You know, there are no shadows on the field right now, so, you know, Durratt is pitching out of the sun, and sometimes when you're blinded a little bit by the sun, that ball will get on you even that much quicker. As Jon Weber, the batter, 3-for-16 on the homestand. He was 0-for-3 last night. First pitch is right down the middle for a strike. Weber hitting .307, going for a little walk outside that left side batter's box. Fixing the batting gloves, adjusting the chapeau. Tapping the plate and looking out toward Alan Durratt. Two hits for Winnipeg, no score. Bottom of the first, nobody out. And a look to third, and then a turn around and look to first base, and nobody popping off the bag very far for Alan Durratt to throw. Trying to get somebody out. Weber, 4 home runs, 31 driven in. The 0-1 swung on and fouled back. Into the sky sweep and back down below. Strike two. For Alan Durant, his 13th start of the year, 3-5 with a 4.43 earned run average. 73 innings of work coming in, 82 hits in those 73. Nothing in two to Weber. Kendall over at third, Roberson is at second. And a throw goes over to first, and diving back in safely is Roberson. And time called. And I think Roberson might have hurt himself a little bit. Tom Baith has come over there to kind of make sure he's okay. And I think he is. Nothing in two to Weber. Alan Durant has given up 44 earned runs in 73 innings, 23 walks, 39 strikeouts, 7 homers, and the opposition batting .293 against him. The pitch is inside, 1-2 to Weber. Weber batting third tonight, DHing. One ball, two strikes, and another throw over to first, and diving back in again and safely at first base is Chris Roberson. For Alan Durant, this is his third start against the Goldeyes this year. A win and a loss, and the ERA at 5.27. 1-2, swing and a miss, and Weber down on strikes on that breaking ball. And Alan Durant has his first strikeout of the night. Here is Sherendel DeCaster. Durant has worked 13 and two-thirds innings against Sioux Falls, allowed 15, or for Sioux Falls against the Goldeyes, allowed 15 hits. And Winnipeg hitting .288 against him. So one away, runners on the corners, and DeCaster with 47 RBI standing in from the right side. First pitch swung on, lifted out toward right. And Carpenter is there. He's going to come in. He'll make the catch. Tagging from third is Kendall. Here comes the throw. It's going to be close. And a head first slide, and they got him. Kendall is out. It's a double play and a great throw by Rich Carpenter from right. And they get Kendall at home plate. So a fly ball out for the second out. And then an outfield assist that goes 9-2. And the Goldeyes come away empty here in the bottom of the first inning. No runs, two hits, and one left. We're scoreless through one. We'll go to the second on TSN 1290.
What makes Tavern United Manitoba's number one sports pub? Service second to none. Food that's right on point. And value that's big league all the way. And this summer, during Tavern United's Your Team, Your Tickets promotion, win weekly prizes and qualify to win season tickets to your Winnipeg Goldeyes, Blue Bombers, and of course, the Jets. So get your friends together for some frothy fun, fabulous food, and guaranteed good times at your New World Sports Pub, Tavern United.
Wow, we're finally doing it. Building our dream home.
I never thought we'd be able to afford it.
Well, we did some good saving, and SCU did the rest.
Sweet. Can this be my room?
This will be the kitchen, bud.
Perfect.
Whether you're fixing, building, or buying, feel comfortable in a mortgage from Steinbach Credit Union. Ready to build? SCU is there with builder mortgages, great rates, and flexible terms. Talk to SCU today. After all, we're taking care of the world's most important mortgage, yours.
Birthdays, office functions, tea parties, whatever. With Archangel Fireworks, every little event becomes a magical backyard affair. So go ahead, rock that next block party. Got a wedding? Bring something blue and then blow it up. Whatever you do, make it a backyard affair with Archangel Fireworks. At Confusion Corner and online at archangelfireworks.com. The sky is your canvas.
You're listening to Goldeyes Baseball Live on TSN 1290. Brought to you in part by Avalon and the Gulf Dome.
Well, we go to the second, and we are scoreless. Cesar Nicolas, Trevor Lawhorn, and Jake Taylor due up for the Pheasants against lefty Rich Hawkins. Glad to have you along tonight. My name is Paul Edmonds. Game two of this three-game series. Not a bad gathering here tonight. Cesar Nicolas will step in from the right side. He was 0 for 3 last night with a walk. Right-handed batter, and he'll face the young lefty from Edmond, Oklahoma. First pitch. Blow it inside, ball one. Quick, which Goldeye was from Edmond, Oklahoma last year? Well, if you guessed Cody Kaiser, you would be correct. The 1-0 is inside, maybe a little bit high, 2-0. This is the third start for Rich Hawkins against Sioux Falls. Last one was on the 21st of this month, the 2-0. Swung on, that is hit high, well deep to left field, way back and gone. A home run for Cesar Nicolas. And you could just tell off the bat that that was not going to come back. And it's 1-0 Sioux Falls as Nicolas hits his ninth of the year in a leadoff blast here to start the second. Well, young Rich Hawkins fell behind 2-0. And now Trevor Lawhorn, Jake Taylor, and Rich Carpenter will be due up. As Lawhorn will stand in from the right side. First pitch, right down the middle for a strike. Well, for Hawkins, that is home run number 6 given up. The 0-1 swung on. That's hit to the gap in right center. And that is going to be caught by Roberson, who dives in the gap and makes the grab. What a diving catch by Chris Roberson on the run. Well, you didn't know if he was going to get there or not. And he had to make up the last couple of strides by diving, and he does, and there's one away on a fantastic catch by Chris Roberson in right center, and there's one down for Jake Taylor. Taylor 0 for 3 last night. First pitch, breaking ball swung on, hit to center field. Roberson got a late jump and will have to take it on a hop. I think he probably didn't see that one. Right off the bat, Jake Taylor will have a little bloop single into center field. And the last start for Rich Hawkins was against Sioux Falls on the 21st. And that was a week ago tonight. 4 2/3 innings, 6 earned runs, 9 hits. Did not factor in the decision. Goldeyes won the game 14-7. First pitch to Rich Carpenter's low, ball one. And then he had a win here on July the 10th against Sioux Falls, 11-3, worked 6 innings. The 1-0 to Carpenter, swung on, and that is lined over short into left field for a base hit. And Rich Carpenter has his first hit against his old club. And there's two on, one in and one out for Alcantara. By the way, folks, drop into Home Run Sports at De La Seigneurie Boulevard and Bishop Grandin, enter to win in the Home Run Sports home run inning. Here's how it works. If a Goldeye player hits a home run in any inning, we pick your name that day, you'll receive an Easton prize package courtesy of Easton Sports. But you must hear your name on this program in order to know that you're a winner. And if you do, afterward, you must contact Home Run Sports within 30 days to claim your prize. You can do that in person or by calling 255-7687. No home runs for Winnipeg last night, so no winners here tonight. Perhaps tonight for tomorrow afternoon. First pitch to Quintana is a breaking ball that's low, ball one. Home run inning brought to you by Home Run Sports. We've got you covered for prospect to pro. Bishop Grandin, one block west of Lajimodier. Home Run Sports, get ready for your game. One in, one out, two on. For the catcher, Al Quintana. The pitch, breaking ball, half a swing. Pitch missed outside, he did not go. Two balls and no strikes. Goldeyes, by the way, have not hit a home run in 4 consecutive starts. The last home run they hit, a 3-run job by Amos Ramon. In Sioux Falls on July 22nd. The 2-0 swung on, ground ball right side. That's going to get through and into right field. They're going to wave in Jake Taylor. Mazzola bobbled the ball, and Taylor will score without a throw. So Quintana will have an RBI single. It'll be 2-0 for Sioux Falls in that RBI single. And we'll see if they charge an error or not. First to third goes Carpenter on that. And here's Joe Anthonson. Four hits all in this inning for Sioux Falls. And they lead it 2-0. And here comes Bill Pulsifer out to have a chat. And Pulsifer, the pitching coach, trying to settle down his young lefty, Rich Carpenter, born in 1990, January 29th, 22 years old, 5'11", 180. Shadows just to the back of the home plate cutout circle. Everybody on the field is in sunshine. Two runs on four hits for Sioux Falls here in the second. Wind is blowing from right to left. Let's have a look at the weather report brought to you by 360winnipeg.ca. Winnipeg's visual directory to win tickets to upcoming Goldeyes games. Go to 360winnipeg.ca and enter to win. Well, in the city, it is sunny and 32 degrees Celsius. First pitch to Anthonson. Fastballs, low, ball one. 32 degrees Celsius translates to 89 Fahrenheit. Humidity 38%. Wind is out of the south at 21, gusting from right to left. More of a factor here tonight. 1-0. Swung on, filleted down the left field line and into the seats. Foul, one ball, one strike. So again, sunny in downtown Winnipeg. 32 Celsius, 89 Fahrenheit, 38% humidity. Wind is south at 21. Anthonson one for two last night with a walk. Still only one out, two in, and runners on the corners here. And Hawkins will come set. The 1-1 is inside. Two balls and one strike. 2-1. Joe Anthonson hitting 251. Lefty-lefty. And Hawkins from the stretch. The 2-1 pitch. In there for a strike. Good fastball, and it's 2-2. You can hear the wind howling tonight. Blowing from right to left. Cesar Nicolas didn't need any help, though, with that home run that he hit. The 2-2. Just missed inside. Allen tried to frame it. Didn't get it from home plate umpire Mike Riggers. Three balls and two strikes. Anthonson steps back in from the left side, batting ninth in the order for the second straight night in this series. The payoff pitch. Swung on, hit on the ground, out towards short, and Duran can't get to it as it kind of split short and third, and the last two C&I singles for Sioux Falls, just unavoidable for Winnipeg to miss them here as a third run will come into score and an RBI single by Anthonson. So everything's seen a hole here for Sioux Falls, and Johnny Kaplan the batter. 3-0 for the Pheasants as they have five hits in the inning. And with the exception of the home run, nothing's been hit hard on those four straight singles. A bloop and two C&I singles. First pitch is bounced out toward third, bobbled by Ramon. He's going to have to hustle to get to the bag at third, and he does, just for the force there of Al Quintana. Well, a bouncing ball out toward Amos, and he kind of bobbled it, then picked it up, and it was a foot race to get Quintana at third. So an unassisted play, and there's two away. Anthonson will get up to second base, and Johnny Kaplan aboard on a fielder's choice. And the batter is Corey Morales, the eighth man to hit in the inning. Hawkins comes set. First pitch is outside, ball one. Three runs, five hits for Sioux Falls here. Morales struck out swinging his first trip. The 1-0. Swung on, fouled away, and out of play. One ball, one strike. Tomorrow, Todd Privet against Mitchell Clegg. A couple of left-handers tomorrow. Privet 4-4 for Winnipeg. Clegg 5-4. The pitch is outside. Throw down to first in the snap. Throw by Allen. And not in time, as getting back in time, Johnny Kaplan. In the count, two balls and one strike. Two balls, one strike to Corey Morales. The pitch swung on, sent down the left field line, and foul or right on the line. That's a foul ball. Foul ball. That was called by the home plate umpire, but it was late. Third base umpire was over in toward the middle of the diamond with a runner at second, and here comes Steve Shirley. Well, it looked to me like it might have landed on the line. And the call was late by Mike Riggers, the home plate umpire. Now, he might have been screened getting out of the way and getting that mask off, and Steve Shirley is going to give him an earful around home plate here. And the argument is going to continue here, and Steve's not very happy. And, you know, it's twofold. One, you think you got the call wrong in Steve's mind, and then how late the call was on that shot over third base down the left field line by Morales. So it's still 3-0, and runners at first and second in the count 2-2. And now these umpires are going to get together in behind the mound and have a confab. Joe Stegner did not make the call. It was the home plate umpire, and it was well over third base. And the call will stand. It's a foul ball. Two balls and two strikes. Andy Juday, the hitting and third base coach for Sioux Falls, probably had the best look at it, and he was waving his guys in right away. Instead, they go back to first and second. Anthonson in second, and Kaplan is in first. 2-2 to Morales. Hawkins comes set. 3-0 Sioux Falls. The pitch is outside. Three balls and two strikes. Morales is 0-5. In this series, the payoff swung on, and that is sent down the left field line. That is going to get into the seats, and that is definitely a foul ball. Three balls, two strikes. Morales batting 311, 7 homers, 38 driven in. The Goldeyes are in a jam and have been all inning. The pitch, breaking ball swung on, hit to the gap in left center. Nobody's going to get to that. It's going to get down and bump up against the wall. Two runs will score on that. Morales will be in standing, and it's a five-run second inning for Sioux Falls here. And Morales comes up with his 39th and 40th RBI of the season. A two-run double for Corey Morales. Well, how many times have you seen it with the Goldeyes of late? Further away an inning where you get two on and nobody out, come away with absolutely nothing in the inning, and then turn around because the momentum's gone to the other team and give up the big inning, and that's what's happened here in the second. A five-run second inning for Sioux Falls. First pitch to Bolden is swung on and hammered down the right field line. That's a fair ball. That gets into the corner. Morales is going to score. Bolden to second, and it's 6-0 for Sioux Falls. as they bat around here in the second. And now they're going to get somebody up in the Goldeyes bullpen. So back-to-back run-scoring doubles for Sioux Falls. And Winnipeg will get some activity in the bullpen. And here's Cesar Nicolas, who started the inning with a home run. Six runs on seven hits, and the 10th man to hit in the inning. And Kaohi Downing will start to throw in the bullpen. Hawkins will come set. First pitch, fastball is low, ball one. You know, it's a deadly combination for a young pitcher like Rich Hawkins, who doesn't throw very hard. And you have a home plate umpire in Mike Riggers and the other guy last night in Joe Stegner that call it real tight to the plate. One ball, no strikes. So you're perpetually pitching from behind. Pitch is low, two balls and no strikes. As Rich has done all inning here, he has been behind every one of these Sioux Falls hitters.
Hold here, here.
6-0 for the Pheasants, who are looking to end a six-game losing skid. Two balls, no strikes to Nicolas, who hit his ninth home run in this inning. The 2-0. Swung on, chopper out towards short, and a backhanded pickup by Duran. Throw to first, nice stretch to Caster. They get Nicolas, and the inning comes to an end. But not before 10 Pheasants step to the plate. Six of them cross it on seven hits and one left. We'll go to the bottom of the second. We'll play some trivia. The Goldeyes have some work to do. It's 6-0 Sioux Falls on TSN 1290.
In business, you need all aspects of your operation working together. Still, the decisions you make in one area can impact another. At MNP, we offer a full range of services from accounting, consulting, and tax, so we can help across all aspects of your operation with the resources and industry-specific knowledge that can help your business grow. Think forward. Contact your local MNP office or visit us online at mnp.ca.
Ever try sucking an orange through a straw? How about five?
Oh, come on!
It can happen, because we're blending up a difference at Juco Juice. Our fresh fruit smoothies knock it out of the park with over five servings of fruit jammed into every 24-ounce cup. This season, make it a mini combo with a zesty Southwest chicken wrap. Get healthy on the go with Juco Juice. Find us at Shaw Park and online at jugojuice.com.
Knowledge is power.
Get the power you need to succeed at CDI College.
With relevant, focused career training for business, healthcare,
art and design, legal, technology, and more.
Learn more.
Earn more.
Get more out of life with a career you love, not just a job.
Find your passion at cdicollege.ca.
CDI College. We change lives through education.
CDI.
I love it, and we will succeed.
Well, we go to the bottom of the second, and the Goldeyes have some work to do. They trail 6-0. Here's Luis Alen, and the first pitch from Alan Durad is low, ball one. 10 men step to the plate in a bat around, 6-run second for Sioux Falls. The 1-0 in there for a strike, and it's 1-1. It's Alan Day and Mazzola. 5-6-7 to face right-hander Alan Durad. And the 1-1 is low, two balls and one strike. For Luis Alen, batting 312. 2-for-4 with a run scored last night. The 2-1 pitch is high, 3-1. You don't have to get all of them back here in the second, but boy, you'd like to push across one or two, wouldn't you? The 3-1. Swung on, ground ball sharply hit by Nicolas at third and into left field for a base hit. And the Goldeyes have the leadoff man aboard for the second straight inning, and here's Kyle Day. And Day 2-for-4 last night in this series with a double. Well, we'll play trivia, and the trivia contest question brought to you by the Place Louis Riel Suite Hotel in downtown Winnipeg. Place Louis Riel, specializing in spacious executive suites. First pitch is on the inside edge for a strike. Well, the contest is open to those that haven't won in the last 30 days. The 0-1 swung on, popped up. Left side of the infield, shallow left, maybe a step into foul territory. Nope, still into fair ground. And Corey Morales makes the catch, and Kyle Day is out number one. And the batter is Josh Mazzola, who is 1-for-15 on this homestand. Luis Alen over at first, one away, bottom of the second, 6-0 Sioux Falls. And the first pitch on the outside edge for a strike. Mazzola batting 286. Leo 1 swung on, filleted to right center. That's going to drop for a base hit, maybe more. Over to pick it up is Carpenter. Striding for second is Mazzola. Here comes the throw, the slide. He is safe. Well, there you go. Luis Alen goes first to third on that. Mazzola has a double in his second hit on this homestand and his first of this series. And here's Amos Ramon. And Amos, 2-for-4 last night, a double and the winning run scored. And he'll stand in from the right side. While up for grabs tonight, if you're the winner on our trivia contest question, you'll pick up a pair of Goldeye tickets to a future home game. You'll also be eligible to win the grand prize of a weekend stay at the Place Louis at the end of the season. First pitch is on the inside edge for a strike. Number to call if you think you know the answer. 780-1290, 780-1290. Here you go, 204, the 0-1. Is a breaking ball that's low. One ball, one strike. Amos hitting 280 on the year. Two home runs, 21 driven in. Goldeyes need a hit right here, though. Need to answer. The 1-1 is low. Two balls and one strike. So there you have it. There's all the parameters. Now you need the question. And we'll do that right after this pitch. The 2-1 to Ramon is low, 3-1. The question tonight is this. Aside from Chris Roberson, who is the only other player this season to play center field for the Goldeyes? Aside from Chris Roberson. The 3-1. Swung on, that is hit to center field. Back goes Johnny Kaplan, going back, and he makes a basket catch in to score as he tags up and comes in from third is Luis Alen. Moving from second to third is Mazzola on a sack fly by Ramon, and a deep fly ball to center field at that for Amos. It's a sacrifice fly, and the Goldeyes are on the board at 6-1. And here's Jose Duran. Well, that was a tough catch for Johnny Kaplan. And to go back and make it over the shoulder basket variety. And Jose Duran with a runner at third base with two away will look to plate him. We've got a winner already on trivia on Softball Saturday. Duran 2-for-4 last night. First pitch. Swung on, chopper out toward third, fielded by Nicolas, and now he throws to first in time, and Duran is out number three. Nice play by Cesar Nicolas, going to his left, had to leap a little bit on that high chopper, came down with it, and Blanton made a good throw. So the Goldeyes get a run on two hits, and they leave one. We'll go to the third. Winnipeg's on the board, but Sioux Falls leads it at 6-1, and the winner of the answer on trivia coming up in the bottom of the seventh. We'll go to the third when we come back with TSN 1290.
Thinking real estate? For a home run every time, choose REMAX. Whether you need to buy or sell a home or lease or sell commercial real estate, REMAX has your bases covered. Plus, they're Winnipeg's number one negotiator. Find your dream home or invest for your future. Outstanding agents, outstanding results. REMAX. Visit REMAX-Winnipeg.com to find your agent today. Granny's Turkey invites you to think big, because now bigger really is better. Look for new Granny's seasoned boneless turkey breast in the frozen food aisle. It's big on flavor, big on nutrition, and it makes chicken breasts and steaks seem so tiny. New Granny's seasoned boneless turkey breast. Great on the grill or any way you like. Bigger is better. Granny's, great taste, healthy living. To find stores offering Granny's seasoned boneless turkey breast, see grannys.ca/barbecue.
Teamwork wins ball games, and it's made Safer Agencies an even stronger player in the insurance business. Recently, Safer Agencies teamed up with Canada's largest personal property insurance company, Intact Insurance. So now, when life throws you a curveball, they'll get you back in the game faster than ever. Are you over 50 with no claims for 3 years? Then you could score big league savings on home insurance, including no deductible on your first claim. Call Safer Agencies for details. 694-6787.
You're listening to Winnipeg Goldeyes Baseball, live on TSN 1290. Brought to you in part by Sirius Technologies. Let's get back to the action with Paul Edmonds.
Well, we go to the third inning. Trevor Lawhorn to lead it off. Rich Hawkins works into his third. 6-1 Sioux Falls. A six-run second for the Pheasants. Goldeyes respond with one. Trail by five. Lawhorn, Taylor, and Carpenter. First pitch. Fastball right down the chute for a strike. Lawhorn is 0 for 1. He flew out to center field. He was up, as were nine other Pheasants in that second inning. The 0-1 swung on, and that is hit out to left center field. That is going to get down, and that will go to the wall as well. Extra bases here for Lawhorn, and he'll be in standing with a leadoff double. So Sioux Falls teeing off here. That's their eighth hit. And their fourth for extra bases. And the Goldeyes will waste no time and get Downing back up in the bullpen to start throwing again. And Jake Taylor will stand in from the right-hand side. One for one, a run scored. Six runs, eight hits for Sioux Falls. First pitch to Taylor. Swung on and fouled back into the mid of Allen, strike one. Well, let's have a look at the Manitoba Blue Cross out-of-town scoreboard. Manitoba Blue Cross, the color of caring. One final today from the American League. And that saw Toronto win their third in a row and beat Detroit 5-1 today. The 0-1 swung on, and that is lined over first down the right field line. That's a fair ball. They're going to wave around Lawhorn. Up with the ball, Mazzola. His throw will be cut off, and it ends up being a double for Taylor. And it's now 7-1 for Sioux Falls, and back-to-back doubles here in this inning. And they now have nine hits, five of them for extra bases. And they've regained their six-run lead. And Rich Carpenter will be the batter. He's one for one with a run scored. Carpenter one for five in the series. But nine hits already and no outs recorded in this third for Sioux Falls. Lefty-lefty here. And Hawkins comes set. First pitch. Inside, ball one. Anderson Alvarez picked up the win for Toronto today to go to 7-7. And they hit three home runs. Edwin Encarnacion is 28th. The 1-0. Curve, swung on, rolled right side, foul. Yunel Escobar, his 7th, and Colby Rasmus, his 18th. Toronto won at 5-1 over Detroit, who've lost 3 in a row. Boston leading the Yankees in New York, 6-3. That's in the 5th. Adrian Gonzalez, a home run for the Red Sox, his 10th. 1-1 to Carpenter. Nobody out, a run in. Runner at second base. 1-1. Swung on, and that is ripped foul over by that first base dugout for Sioux Falls. And ricochets off that railing and meshing down the right field line. 1-2. Jason Nix and Chris Stewart have homered for the Yankees. Nix is 4th, Stewart is 1st. 1-2, curve, swung on, wrapped right side, foul. And this just in as well. Seattle got by Kansas City, 4-3. So another final in the American League. Kevin Millwood, the win for the Mariners. Jesus Montero connected for his 10th home run. The pitch, curve, swung on, line to right field. That will drop for a base hit. Likely get in another run. Here comes Mazzola's throw. It'll be cut off by DeCaster, and the run will score without the ball coming home. And here comes Rick Forney, and that is going to be it here for Rich Hawkins. As it's an RBI single for Rich Carpenter. 2 runs have scored in this inning, and it's 8-1 in favor of Sioux Falls. And Rich will have a very short evening here. He'll hand the ball off to his manager, and the Goldeyes will get into the bullpen. Tough start for Rich Hawkins. We'll take a timeout on the call of the bullpen being made. 8-1 in favor of Sioux Falls. See if the Goldeyes can cauterize the wound here and get back in this one. Right now they've got to stop the bleeding, and we'll see if they can do that with Kaohi Downing stepping in when we step back on TSN 1290.
For football.
One of the best trades ever in the history of the CFL, arguably, to get Doug Brown here for basically a box of tape.
For hockey.
First 4 guys in the NHL draft most years are can't miss.
Nothing but sports.
You lead the league in anonymous quotes. You also lead the league in dysfunction.
When sports is your passion.
There's an emotion in the city, and it permeates the dressing room and the players. They all feel it.
Turn to the station that's even crazier about sports than you are.
I want to be like the Road Warriors. They had the football pads with the spikes coming out and then all the face paint and stuff.
As long as you wear tight shorts, I'm in.
I heard that about you.
Spiky shoulder pads and tight shorts.
I think you still got the panties somewhere around here, Troy, if you want to slip into something a little more comfortable.
Troy really is a sensitive guy. I want spikes and shoulder pads and, like, mean-looking face paint. Troy wants tights.
Well, almost as crazy. TSN 1290. All sports, all the time.
Well, we're in the 3rd. There's nobody out, and 2 runs have scored. And that will be it for Rich Hawkins here tonight. 2-plus innings, 10 hits, 8 runs, all earned. Responsible for 1, pitcher of record on the losing side. No walks, 2 strikeouts. Pitching change brought to you by Johnson Waste Management, 452-0909. As Kaohi Downing will step in and try to get through this 3rd. There's nobody out, and he'll face Al Quintana. And the first pitch. Fastball swung on, bounced out toward 3rd. This might be tough. Barehanded pick up there by Ramon on a running play on the infield, and he throws to 1st in time. Nice play on a charge on the infield by Amos Ramon, and he barehanded it. No glove required. And he throws to get Quintana for the first out. Nice play. And there's one away for Rich Carpenter, who's up to second base, and Joe Anthonson at the plate now. 8-1, Sioux Falls leads it. So 1 away, 2 in, Carpenter at second, and Anthonson has an RBI single already, and he'll step in from the left side. And the first pitch is a fastball in there for a strike. Downing from Hawaii. Been with the team all year, a right-hander, 5'11", 180. 26 years old now, as he had a birthday way back in May. The 0-1. Inside, 1-1. Well, it's certainly a different look. Kaohi throws harder than Rich Hawkins. And obviously from the right side. One ball, one strike to Joe Anthonson. And the pitch. Swung on, chopper fouled the plate. It's 1-2. Third inning, Baltimore and Oakland are scoreless. Also in the third, Cleveland leads Minnesota 1-0. Coming up at 7:05 tonight, Chicago White Sox at Texas. And at 8:05, Tampa at the Angels in Anaheim. Couple of finals from games in the National League today. The pitch is high, 2-2. Chicago Cubs beat St. Louis, 3-2. And the Dodgers shut out San Francisco, 10-0. Barry Zito took the loss for the Giants. Chad Billingsley, the win for the Dodgers. And they got home runs from Kemp and A.J. Ellis. 2-2. Curve swung on and missed, and he's down on strikes. Good pitch. Strikeout number one for Downing here tonight. And that's three for Goldeyes pitching. Back to the top of the order, and Johnny Kaplan, who's 0-2 with a run scored. It's 8-1 Sioux Falls, runner at second, two away now. Third inning, Pittsburgh and Houston are tied at one. Houston got a home run from Alex Presley. First pitch is low, ball one, his eighth. Houston's lost 11 in a row. Milwaukee and Washington are scoreless in the third. And Atlanta leading Philadelphia 1-0 in the third. The Braves have won three in a row. Pitch is swung on and missed, and it's 1-1. Another good breaking ball there. And Miami trying to end a three-game skid. They lead at home over San Diego 1-0 in the third. Coming up at 7:10, Cincy in Colorado. Reds have won eight in a row. And at 7:10 as well, Mets at Arizona. 1-1 is high. Two balls and one strike. Of course, we'll also update you on the American Association, and there is CFL action tonight as well. Two balls, one strike. The pitch. Breaking ball swung on, hit on the ground, out to short. Up with it off two hops as Durant throw to first. And that is it for Sioux Falls here in the top of the third inning. Now they get two more runs on three hits, and they leave one. We'll go to the bottom of the third. Sioux Falls leads it 8-1 on TSN 1290.
We asked Winnipeggers what makes Fergie's fish and chips at the Forks so good.
Every order is made fresh while you wait.
Oh, if you love authentic English-style fish and chips, Fergie's is the real deal.
The fries are fresh cut from Manitoba potatoes. They're excellent.
They only use non-hydrogenated oil, a healthier choice.
It's just so good. Fergie's is fishalicious.
Fergie's fish and chips at the Forks.
The place for great fish and chips.
Fishalicious!
What if I told you that chiropractic care is highly effective in treating the injuries sustained in car accidents, and that the costs associated with your chiropractic care and recovery are fully covered through Manitoba Public Insurance? And what if I told you all you have to do is concentrate on getting well? Would you be interested? Manitoba chiropractors are passionate about improving the lives of all Manitobans, helping injured motorists gain relief from their pain and suffering.
Manitoba chiropractors. Making life better.
It's Ken, and I'm just not going to do a regular commercial here. I'll tell you what Ken would do. Ken would read the whole ad on this here Kenwood two-way radio from Prairie Mobile. It's tough. Watch. See? Kenwood two-way radios will keep your business connected without the cell phone bill. Scramble features, and did I mention? It's tough. Two-way radios from Kenwood. It's what Ken would do, and you should too.
After the sale, it's the service that counts. Prairie Mobile, your Kenwood authorized dealer.
Well, we go to the bottom of the third inning. Top of the order for the Goldeyes, Kendall, Roberson, and Weber. Winnipeg trailing 8-1 here tonight. Alan Durant works into his third. Sioux Falls getting six in the second, a deuce in this third. Winnipeg getting one last inning. First pitch to Kendall. Is outside, ball one. The 1-0. Inside and low, 2-0. Well, everything else is a little bit of a later start in the American Association, except for one game. The 2-0 is outside, 3-0. Grand Prairie at Kansas City at 7:05. Sioux City at Lincoln, 7:05. Same with Quebec and St. Paul. Wichita and Laredo at 7:30, 3-0. Low, ball four. Amarillo at El Paso at 8:05. And Fargo in the only other game that started at 6. Or just after, leads Gary 2-0 in the third. The Goldeyes are four games back of Fargo. And the standings are trailing by 7 here. And we'll get Mike Meyer out to have a little chat with Alan Durratt. And Al Quintana, probably about the leadoff walk there, as if to say, okay, listen, you've got a 7-run lead here. Let's not walk the park and allow them to get back in it. Throw strikes. Make them hit their way to get on. As Chris Roberson, 1-for-1 tonight, steps up and in. And in the Canadian Football League, Saskatchewan leads Hamilton 22-14. 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Coming up at 8 o'clock tonight, BC and Calgary. That is our first look at the Manitoba Blue Cross out-of-town scoreboard. Mound meeting's over, first pitch. Outside, ball one. That's five straight balls thrown by Alan Durratt. 8 runs, 10 hits for Sioux Falls. 1-4 for Winnipeg, 1-0. In there for a strike, and it's 1-1. Now Chris Roberson with a base hit in the first, extended a hitting streak to 12 straight. The 1-1 is on the inside edge for a strike, and it's 1-2. Roberson is 8-for-18 on the homestand. The 1-2 swung on and fouled into a sky sweep back down below. Still a ball and two strikes. 8-for-18 means you're hitting .444. 1-2. And the pitch. Swung on, ground ball left side. That's going to get through between short and third. And just like the first, Kendall and Roberson are aboard with nobody out. And here comes Jon Weber. And Weber will step up and in from the left-hand side. John struck out his first trip. And so far is 0-for-4 with two strikeouts in this series. First pitch. Swung on and that's fouled away. Left side and on top of the roof here at Shaw Park. I don't know, I'd say 5,400 here tonight. The 0-1 swung on, that's lifted out toward left field. Jared Bolden will be there and he'll make the catch. And there'll be one away for Sharundel DeCaster. And DeCaster will step in from the right side. He flew out to right field. His first trip, he's 0-for-1. And DeCaster has hits in 8 of his last 9 games. Runners at first and second. First pitch, runners on the move, pitches in there for a strike, throw down to third, not in time. Head first slide at third and a stolen base for Bryce Kendall, his 16th of the year. And on the back end of that, Roberson will swipe his 21st.
Oh dear.
Strike one on DeCaster, and now with one away, a base hit probably plates two, but he could also get a sack fly here. The 0-1 is low, 1-1. One ball, one strike. And the pitch. Breaking ball is low, 2-1. The 2-1. Swung on, line to the gap in left center. That's going to get down and score both runs. In to score is Kendall. On his heels, Roberson. RBI single, Schirundel to Caster. And it's 8-3. Well, that's the big hit Winnipeg needed right there to kind of jumpstart things here. And Luis Alen the batter. And for DeCaster, RBI 48-49 now. And Alen will step in from the right-hand side. First pitch, swung on, and that is lined out to second, caught by Anthonson, throw to first, not in time. DeCaster got back to beat out the double-off attempt. Hard hit ball by Alen, but right at Anthonson, so out number two recorded on a liner. And here's Kyle Day. Now the first pitch is in there for a strike. And the 0-1. Swung on, chopper over the mound, back up the middle, backhanded pickup off the glove, though, of Anthonson. Kind of looking at second base and not fully focused on squeezing the baseball, and he went to make a backhanded pickup, had it go off the heel of the glove, and Kyle Day will call that an infield single, and everybody's safe at first and second. DeCaster gets to second, and here's Josh Mazzola. Well, I'll tell you what, you hit a home run right here, and you are right back in this, baby. 8-3 Sioux Falls. We're in the bottom of three, and Alen Durratt will come set, check DeCaster at second. First pitch, curve in there for a strike. Mazzola, 1-for-1 tonight. He had a double to right center. And the second, the 0-1. Swung on, that's hit to the gap in left center. That's well cracked. That's going to get down. It's going to go all the way to the wall. In to score to Caster. They're going to hold up Day at third. In standing at second is Mazzola with an RBI double, and it's 8-4 Sioux Falls. And now Amos Ramon, the batter. And Ramon has an RBI off a sack fly tonight, so he does not have an official at bat. And Ramon will step in from the right-hand side. And Durratt will come set. First pitch is high, ball one. One ball, no strikes. The pitch. Swung on, foul back. Good hack there by Ramon. And it's strike one as he put that back by the press box here and behind home plate. One ball, one strike. Amos is 5-for-12 in the homestand. 2-for-4 in the series with a double, an RBI, and a run scored. The 1-1. Is high, 2-1. Sioux Falls getting a right-hander up in the bullpen down there. Some long toss going on. And the 2-1 swung on and fouled back. And that will get into the seats for a souvenir. no shortage of runs so far. We've had 12. No shortage of hits. We've had 18. Runners at second and third for Winnipeg, two away, and a 2-2 count on the right-handed swinging third baseman. Righty-righty, Duratcom set the pitch. Is high, 3-2 to Famous Amos. Amos, two home runs, 21 driven in. Hitting 280 coming in. Day at third, Mazzola at second. The payoff pitch, swing and a miss, and he's down on strikes. And the Goldeyes will get three runs. And they do so here on four hits and leave a pair both in scoring position. We go to the fourth. Well, they're kind of back in it here. Goldeyes get three runs in the inning. They trail 8-4 after three. We'll go to the fourth. We come back on TSN 1290.
Seems like yesterday he could barely throw the ball. Now my glove hand's on fire. My boy's got quite an arm.
His fastball may be ready for heavy hitters, but he may not be ready for...
Come on, man. Don't be a wuss. It's just a little chew. Try it.
Talk to your kids about chewing tobacco today. Because if you think you've prepared them for everything, you don't know spit.
Brought to you by Mantra, the Manitoba Tobacco Reduction Alliance for tobacco-free sport.
Summer in Manitoba sizzles all over the place, from our great beaches to our great ballpark. And I just don't mean on the field. I mean on Goldie's Grill, where they sizzle up some of the best hot dogs you've ever tasted. Diamond Dogs, the official hot dog of the Goldeyes, custom made by Winkler Meats. Diamond Dogs are naturally smoked, gluten and allergen free, and made with quality ingredients that deliver full flavor every bite. Try them at the game or pick them up at your local grocer. Diamond Dogs from Winkler Meats. Product quality is our tradition.
A little of this. A little of that. A little of this. A little of that. And a whole lot of whatever in between.
Funky Cole Medina.
Give me the news, I got a bad case.
99.9 Bob FM. 80s, 90s, and whatever.
It's time to get back into the action. Batter up. Turn it up. This is Goldeyes Baseball on TSN 1290. Now back to the voice of the Goldeyes, Paul Edmonds.
Well, we go to the fourth inning. And Sioux Falls leading by four at 8-4. And for them, Corey Morales, Jared Bolden, and Cesar Nicolas. And the first pitch from Kaohi Downing is outside, ball one. And Goldie down by our crowd mic with a water gun, entertaining some of the fans there. The 1-0 to Morales. Fastball on the outside edge for a strike. They tell us 5,318 here tonight. 53-18. Not a bad gathering, the 1-1. Swung on, and that's lifted out toward right. And Mazzola in, now back a couple of steps, and underneath it, up with two hands, and he makes the catch, one away. And Jared Bolden, the batter, he's one for two.
Next up on field, number 12, Jared Bolden.
And Bolden struck out in the first and had an RBI double. Well, here tonight, Sioux Falls has 10 hits. Half of them for extra bases. Four doubles and a homer. Downing comes set. First pitch to Bolden. Fastball, low, ball one. Sioux Falls scoring six in the second. The Goldeyes getting one back in that inning. Pheasants added two more in the third. The Goldeyes got three back. Pitch is low, 2-0. So you are a grand slam away from tying this thing up if you're Winnipeg. With a lot of baseball still to play, we're only in the fourth inning. Two balls, no strikes. And the pitch. Fastball swung on, comebacker knocked down by Downing. Finds it by his feet, picks it up and throws to first. Two away. A hot shot comebacker, and Kaohi knocked it down. And again, almost like Durant earlier, a bit of a protectionary move first rather than thinking about getting the out. But once you've knocked it down and you're all right and you can find it, well, instincts take over to pick up the baseball, throw it to first. So 1-3 put out, two down for Cesar Nicolas. And now they're going to make sure that everybody's okay. As Downing goes out. Or Forney goes out along with Shane Zadiviak. The athletic therapist to make sure that Downing's okay. And Rick Forney, the field manager, now comes off as well. And oh, he just... probably a little bit more shocked than anything else. He was smiling out there. He's all right. Cesar Nicolas, a home run and a ground out tonight. And the home run was majestic. First pitch, low and inside, ball one. I mean, he hit it high and he hit it deep. And you could help. You could hear the way it sounded off the bat that it was not going to stay in the ballpark. I mean, it was crack. The 1-0. In there for a strike, and it's 1-1. 8-4, Sioux Falls were in the top of four. Nicolas connected for his ninth tonight. He has 56 RBI to lead this Sioux Falls team. Two away in the frame. Downing is retired, five straight. The 1-1 is a breaking ball that's low. 2-1. Tomorrow, 1:35, these teams conclude this series. We'll be on the air at noon, 55 with Forney. And then 1 o'clock, the pregame show for Winnipeg Insurance, the 2-1. On the inside edge for a strike, it's 2-2.
Nailed it.
Then next week on Sunday, we'll have 55 with 40 from Sioux City. And then we'll skip a week because August the 12th, the Goldeyes don't play. 2-2. Swung on, chopper out towards short. Three hopper up with it. Duran shuffles and throws to first. And that is it. Sioux Falls near the top of the fourth. They go 1-2-3 for the first time since the first. Nice job by Downing so far in this appearance. Six up, six down. We'll go to the bottom of four. 8-4 Pheasants. Goldeyes baseball from downtown on TSN 1290.
The Mediterranean.
The Greek.
The Mediterranean.
The Greek.
Even if you can't agree on what kind of pizza to get, at least everyone in Winnipeg agrees where to get it. Santa Lucia Pizza. For the sixth straight year, you and Uptown Magazine readers voted Santa Lucia best pizza in Winnipeg. They've also received the Consumer Choice Award for best pizza restaurant. Whether it's dine-in, takeout, or home delivery, Winnipeg agrees. Santa Lucia Pizza is the best in town.
You see, the best ingredients make the best of the pizza.
That baseball glove. You know the one. The one that you got in high school. The one that got you MVP your senior year. Yeah, you know the one. And we do too. At Ranger Insurance, we protect what's important to you. Because whatever size it is, it's the little things that matter. Whether it's home, life, auto, or commercial, Ranger Insurance has a plan that's right for you. For the protection you deserve, visit rangerinsurance.ca.
Your best friend may be furry, but they're part of your family. So when it comes to your pet's health, they deserve to be treated like family at Animal Hospital of Manitoba. Their experienced professionals provide the very latest in veterinary care for cats, dogs, ferrets, rabbits, just about any pet you can imagine. And they take pride in educating clients and following up to make sure your best friend is doing just fine. Animal Hospital of Manitoba, 995 Main Street. We care for your pets as if they were our own.
Well, we go to the bottom of the fourth inning. 8-4, Sioux Falls leading. As the big inning was a six-run second, it's the difference right now. It's Duran, Kendall, and Roberson. First pitch from Alan Durad is swung on and lined over first down the right field line. Over to pick it up is Carpenter. And stopping at first base with a leadoff single is Jose Duran. Well, that's a good start to this inning as well. Now, as I've said, probably ad nauseum over the years, you've got to, in one of these situations, either it gets away on you and you never recover, or you just try to chip away. Here's Bryce Kendall. He's been aboard twice, one for one, a walk, a stolen base, and a run scored. And Alan Durant working into his fourth. First pitch is on the inside edge for a strike. Well, Sioux Falls, 8 runs, 10 hits. The Goldeyes have 4 runs and 9 hits. And a throw goes over to first, and hopping back in safely is Jose Duran. Kendall has hits in 7 of 8. Pitches in there for a strike, and it's nothing and two. And Price is 2 for 6 in the series. Durant will come set. The 0-2 swung on, chopper foul off the instep. And at the plate, nothing and two. Well, congratulations, Price Kendall. It is your birthday today. And there was... I don't know what was exchanged, but they had a little mock party for him in the clubhouse before batting practice, and there was some gifts there. I didn't want to hang around for that. And a throw over to first base, and Duran back in time. Price is 27 years old today. I'm sure there was a couple of those gag gifts that were unopened today. You know, you peel off the corner, see what it is. I am not opening that. The 0-2. Breaking ball swung on, bounced out toward third. Up off the chest of Nicolas. Now he throws to first, and it's not in time. Well, a simple case of a ground ball that should be turned for two, and you have a veteran that looks over at second, takes his eye off the ball, thinking about how much time he's got to get the guy at second. Then it goes off your chest because you didn't pick it up cleanly. You bobble it a little bit, pick it up, throw to first, and you got a speedy runner that beats it out. And that should be an error, and it is. And the Goldeyes will benefit by having two on and nobody out. On the air by Cesar Nicolas. So E5. And Roberson the batter. 2 for 2 tonight. A stolen base and a run scored. The tying run on the on-deck circle for Winnipeg right now. And Jon Weber. 8-4 Sioux Falls. We're in the bottom of four. Roberson singles in the first and third. Durant will come set. And the pitch. Swung on, ground ball out towards short. Backhanded Olay by Morales. Throw to second for one. Relay down to one, not in time. And the ball gets away from first baseman Lawhorn. And Vaith was waving in Jose Duran from third, but he stayed there and didn't come in. So Roberson will beat it out for a fielder's choice. There'll be runners on the corners. A hard hit ball and a backhanded Olay by Morales. And he came up with it, threw to second to force out Kendall. And the out goes 6-4, and there's one down for Jon Weber, who's 0-for-2 tonight, and 0-for-5 with a walk in the series. Again, you don't need a pile here, but you got to get Duran in from third. And Jon Weber steps in from the left side. Durant will come set. First pitch is low, ball one. Bottom of the fourth inning, 8-4 Sioux Falls here. Duran at third, Roberson at second. The 1-0 outside, 2 balls and no strikes. Well, what do you think the chances of Roberson going to second to try to break up a double play possibility are here with Weber ahead in the count at 2-0? The 2-0. Is just on the outside corner for a strike, and it's 2-1. Roberson has stolen base tonight on the back end of a double steal for his team-leading 21st. And a throw goes over to first, and diving back in is Chris Roberson safely. We're in the bottom of four. Wild game here tonight. Lots of runs on the board. Weber, 31 RBI, four home runs. And another throw goes over to first, and diving again back in is Roberson. Two balls, one strike to Jon Weber. From Lakewood, California. The pitch. Swung on, chopper fouled the plate. Did that come up and almost get Weber in the face? 2-2. I think he's all right. Two balls, two strikes. Rick Forney wants to come down. Say, did you get it around the eye? And John says, I'm all right. 2-2. Weber has struck out tonight and flown out to left. Winnipeg would take a fly ball right now to get Duran in from third. Durant comes set, and a step toward third, and a look back at first. That's that move that Major League Baseball is thinking about taking out of the game next year. 2-2. The pitch. Swung on, line to the gap at left center. That's going to get down, and it's going to go all the way to the wall. In to score Durant. Scoring from first is Roberson. And hobbling his way into second is Weber with a two-run double. And it's 8-6 Sioux Falls. Weber's first hit of the series, RBI 32 and 33.
Baby.
And here's Sherundel DeCaster, who represents the potential tying run here right now with one away and two in. And Weber standing at second base. And here comes Mike Meyer out to have a little chat as the pitching coach. And now Sioux Falls is going to get some people up in the bullpen. And everybody from the infield, except for the left side, Morales and Nicolas, the shortstop and third baseman, join the meeting. Toronto DeCaster, a two-run single tonight. Good at bat from Jon Weber. Got a pitch he could handle, and he doubles to left center the other way. And the Goldeyes have 10 hits to equal Sioux Falls' 10 hits. And Winnipeg trailing by just two now. They were down 8-1. One swing of the bat might tie this baby. First pitch, swung on and popped up. Foul territory, first base side. Lawhorn underneath it, and he makes the catch for the second out. And now Luis Alen, the batter. And Louis, one for two. Base hit to lead off the second, scored a run, then he lined out to Joe Anthonson at second base. Right-hander up in throwing in the bullpen for the Pheasants. And it's Barry Fowler, former Goldeye. First pitch, inside, ball one. Barry was in a movie in the offseason back home in Georgia. And then just came to Sioux Falls sort of uninvited and hung around till they needed him. Pitch is swung on and hammered high and deep to left field. Way back, Bolden at the warning track at the wall. He'll look up, pucker up, and kiss it goodbye. And we are tied. Louis Alen with a home run is fourth of the year. Make the turn at third and come on down. And the Goldeyes have come back from a seven-run deficit and tied it at eight in the bottom of this fourth.
Baby.
How about that? and a rocket ship to left. RBI 35 and 36. And here's Kyle Day. Although we're going to get a pitching change here, Alan Durratt will come out of the baseball game. Second visit, this time by the manager, spells automatic relief. And we've got a brand new ball game. 72nd timeout on the call of the bullpen. Barry Fowler trots in when we trot back. Tied at 8. Who would have thunk it in downtown on TSN 1290?
For football.
Are you guys concerned about a 23-year-old who's had major reconstructive surgery on both his shoulders already?
Absolutely. Yeah, and shoulders for an O-lineman is everything, right? Because you're constantly punched, stepping punched.
For hockey.
I think it's a shame that the Toronto Maple Leafs take the kind of money they do from their fans, and they haven't been to the playoffs in 7 years. They haven't won a Stanley Cup since 1967. The Montreal Canadiens. Since 1993.
For Goldeyes.
Back of the warning track. At the wall, and he makes the catch.
Nothing but sports.
I mean, either you love him or you hate him, and I bet there's a lot of people out there that used to hate him that are starting to love him. The guy's the best thing to happen to Major League Baseball in a long time.
When sports is your passion.
It's like you're talking to a 12-year-old kid who's refusing to take responsibility for whatever that they had done. And you don't want guys like that. I don't care how talented they are.
TSN 1290. All sports.
You want guys like that on your team?
All the time.
Well, old friend Barry Fowler was with the Goldeyes last year. He was kind of that interesting story, that 35-year-old guy that had a career in sort of the oil business and was doing fairly well, but still wanted to chase the dream of playing professional baseball. And here he is in his second year with Sioux Falls. We are tied at 8, and that's it for Alan Durratt. So both starters have been knocked out of the baseball game. For Durratt, 3 2/3 innings tonight. 11 hits. 8 runs. And, you know, I'm thinking that those last two for sure will not be earned. So 8 runs, 6 are earned, a walk, a strikeout, and he gives way to Barry Fowler. This pitching change is brought to you by Johnson Waste Management, 452-0909. And the fourth inning continues here. And Kyle Day, the batter, to face Fowler. Who's wearing number 29. Kyle Day is 1-for-2 tonight. And the first pitch from the right-hander. Low and inside, ball one. Barry Fowler from Atlanta, Georgia. 6'1", 215.36 years old. The 1-0. Swing and a miss, and it's 1-1. Barry will be 37 next month on August 23rd. 36 years old, 37 next month. The 1-1. Change up, swung on, and missed, and it's 1-2. One and two. And the pitch swung on and fouled back. For Barry, this is his second appearance of the season. No record and a 5.40 ERA. 1 2/3 innings. No hits. A run was earned. He walked one, struck one out. Faced six batters. 1-2. Swung on, ground ball out towards short. Up with it, Morales. And he throws to first, and that is it here in this fourth inning for Winnipeg. But what an inning it was. They get all four back to tie. They do so on a total of three hits, including a two-run double by Jon Weber, and a two-run homer by Luis Alen. Nobody left. We'll go to the fifth. Brand new ball game. Tied at 8. TSN 1290.
Hello, Ken Plain here. If you're looking for a foundation contractor that you can trust, go with Avalon. But don't just take my word for it. For over 40 years, people in Winnipeg and surrounding areas have gone with Avalon for their foundation issues. So you know that you are dealing with professionals. To learn more, log on to avalonwinnipeg.ca. Go with the name you trust. Go with Avalon Construction.
In the world of PowerSmart, small changes add up. Did you know planting shrubs and trees around your house can shade your windows in summer and can help protect your house from chilly winter winds? Drafty windows are uncomfortable and waste energy. Sealing and re-weather stripping your windows and adding window insulator kits are an effective way to save energy and money while improving the comfort of your home. For more energy-saving solutions from Manitoba Hydro, log on to manitobapowersmart.ca.
Remember life on the other side? At the mercy of mosquitoes and Mother Nature? Good thing you called Best Windows and Doors and discovered just how awesome summer is in a SunSpace sunroom. SunSpace offers solid 2-inch wall construction and great options. Plus, they're simple to use and easy to clean. No bugs, no bad weather, just sweet summer living. Discover SunSpace sunrooms today from Best Windows and Doors, where the best is all we do. 1676 St. James.
You're listening to Goldeyes Baseball Live on TSN 1290. Brought to you in part by Fergie's Fish and Chips and Manitoba Turkey Producers.
Well, we go to the fifth inning in an 8-8 tie. First pitch right down the chute from Kaohi Downing to Trevor Lawhorn, and the fifth is underway. Wild one here tonight in downtown. And the 0-1 swung on, line to center field. Roberson, now he'll get there and make the catch. Boy, he kind of ducked and he moved back and he didn't know if he was going to see it. He's in the shade right now, but that's two that have kind of mystified him a little bit. But he makes the catch on that one. Hard hit ball by Lawhorn to center field. We'll call it a liner to center, one away. And here's Jake Taylor. Stands in from the right-hand side. First pitch. Swung on, fouled back. Downing works into his third inning. It has been 7-up, 7-down. Goldeyes have 8 runs on 11 hits. Sioux Falls, 8 runs on 10 hits. And the lone error in the game, the 0-1. Breaking ball in there for a strike. That's a beauty. Taylor tonight, 2 for 2. A single, a double, an RBI, and 2 runs scored. Nothing and 2 to Jake Taylor. The pitch. Swung on, and that is hit out towards second. And taken nicely on that one short hop by Kendall. He made sure he had it. Took it in the press basket. Throws to first. 2-1. That's the way you teach the kids. Just get in front of it, Steve, with the ball. Even if you don't get it in your hand or glove right away, and you bobble a little bit, at least from the middle infield standpoint, you'll have a chance to get the runner. But if it gets a little bit behind you, to the side of you, you have to step to pick it up, you're probably lost. Here's Rich Carpenter, 2 for 2, first pitch. Swung on and missed for strike one, good fastball. Well, this must be interesting for these two, both from Hawaii and both teammates for 60 games of the year and now facing each other as opponents. The 0-1 is just outside with a fastball, 1-1. Well, you play long enough, though, and you're going to face friends that you grew up with, played with on other teams as you go forward in your career. 1-1 outside, 2 balls and 1 strike. Ridge has had a good night. He's 2 for 2 tonight. A run scored and an RBI. Two balls and one strike. The pitch. Fastball swung on, bounce right side, foul. 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Downing comes set, and the pitch. Oh, way inside, he just hit him. Don't think he meant to do that. Carpenter, between he and Bryce Kendall, were leading the team in hit bats, or being hit by pitch. Kendall's been hit 9 times to lead the Goldeyes. And for Carpenter now, that is his 8th hit by pitch. Here's Alcantara, 1-for-2, first pitch right down the chute for a strike, good fastball. Quintana, 1-for-2, an RBI single in the second, bounced out corner to corner in the third. We're in the 5th, we're tied at 8. 2 away, runner at first base, and Ridge Carpenter, who's 6-for-8 on the base paths. Downing comes set, righty-righty here, the 0-1. Curve a little bit high, 1-1. So that's the first base runner for Sioux Falls against Kaohi Downing, who had retired 8 in a row since coming in. 1-1 to Quintana. The pitch, high and tight, 2-1. Came back with a fastball there again. Two balls and a strike to the right-handed swinging catcher for Sioux Falls, who's hitting 302. Couple of homers, the pitch. Swung on, high chopper out towards short. Fielded there, throw to second. Do they force him? Yes, they do. Bang, bang at second. And a high chopper that Duran had to come down with, and he threw to second. And they force Carpenter. And it was bang, bang. Boy, the Goldeyes might have got the call right there. And the out goes 6-4. And that is it for Sioux Falls in the 5th. No runs, no hits, and 1 left. Bottom 5 is next. Tied at 8, TSN 1290.
Hi, this is Danny from Danny's Whole Hog Barbecue.
And I'm quarterback Buck Pierce, here to introduce Danny and Buck's barbecue sauces.
The official barbecue sauce of your Winnipeg Blue Bombers.
It's an all-star lineup featuring raspberry chipotle,
roasted garlic and honey,
and cranberry chipotle. Whether you pour it, dip it, or spread it,
they're delicious and make a perfect gift.
Try Danny and Buck's barbecue sauces today. Available at the Bomber Store.
And we'll bring the flavor.
One little drop of oil can spoil a million drops of water. So put used oil in its place. Call or click for information.
Used Oil Recycling is giving away free Goldeyes key tags at 12 select home games this season with 3 ways to win. If the number on the back of your key tag is drawn in the second inning, you can win a $50 gift certificate from Future Shop. If you activate your key tag online and your keys are ever lost, they'll be returned for free. Once your key tag is activated, you are entered for a chance to win an autographed Goldeyes jersey. The draw will take place at the last game of the season. Mr. Oil Drop reminds you to keep your environment clean and green by recycling your used oil and antifreeze products.
Call 1-888-410-1440.
Make every drop count.
Well, we go to the bottom of the 5th inning. My name is Paul Edmonds, and our operator back at our studios in South Winnipeg is Rob Innes. Dana Robbie helping us out on site. And we're tied at 8. The Goldeyes trailed 8-1 at one point. As Josh Mazzola will step up, he's doubled twice tonight. Barry Fowler works into his second inning. It's Mazzola, Ramon, and Duran. 16 runs, 21 hits combined so far. First pitch is a little bit high, ball one. Zola doubled in the second and doubled homer run in the third. Sioux Falls has batted around tonight. They sent 10 to the plate in a 6-run second, the 1-0. swung on, filleted out toward right. On the run, Carpenter, and he will reach and make the catch toward the line, end up in foul territory. And there's one down. Nice grab by Rich Carpenter. And here's Amos Ramon, who's 0 for 1 with a sacrifice fly and an RBI tonight. And the Goldeyes have sent 8 to the plate in one inning and 7 to the plate in another. And the first pitch is in there for a strike. And the 0-1 is outside. One ball, one strike. Amos hitting 280 on the year. The 1-1 pitch from Fowler. Breaking ball down and away, 2-1. Couple of homers and 22 driven in this season. And the pitch swung on. That's hit sharply up to short by a dive in Morales and into left center. And Amos will make a big turn at first and hold up with a one-out single. So Ramon with a hit here tonight. And he's hit same plate both games in this series. And Jose Duran the batter. And Duran will step up and in from the right-hand side. Now the first pitch to him. Swung on, chopper left side, foul. Well, one thing about Jose, he is aggressive. He'll go after that first pitch, and I think he broke his bat. And he'll walk back to the Goldeyes third base dugout and get a new stick. And now back toward home plate. They've kicked the lights on here, but lots of daylight left. We're at 7:50, 10 minutes before 8 o'clock Central. Nothing in one to Jose Duran. One out, one on. Fowler will come set. We're tied at 8. The pitch is inside. One ball, one strike. Tomorrow, Todd Privett versus Mitchell Clegg. A couple of lefties. 1:35 first pitch. And the Goldeyes will have tomorrow night off and Monday off to travel to Kansas City. 1-1. Breaking ball, swung on and missed. And it's 1-2. Fargo and Gary tonight. Goes over to first base and diving back in is Ramon. Amos is 6 for 6 on the base paths. One away in the inning. 1-2 count on Jose Duran. And another throw over to first base and Amos dives back in safely. Fargo leads Gary 4-1 in the bottom of 6. One ball, two strikes. The pitch. Swung on. Chopper out toward third. Fielded there by Nicolas. Throws to second for one. Down to one. Not in time. Nice play. Going to his right and leaping to pull that down by Cesar Nicolas. Duran hits into a fielder's choice. They get Amos Ramon at second base. And a 5-4 put out. There's two down. Back to the top of the order in Price Kendall. Grand Prairie leads Kansas City 3-0. And that is in the second. And in the third, St. Paul leading Quebec 2-0. Here's Kendall tonight. 1 for 2, a walk and a run scored. First pitch is in there for a strike. And a throw over to first base, and back in time is Jose Duran, 17 of 21 on the base paths. After the Goldeyes fell behind 8-1 after 2.5, the pitch swung on, fell back. They scored 3 in the third, 4 in the fourth to tie it at 8. Yeah, rally time early on here tonight. Neither starter is in the game any longer, as you might expect. Throw over to first, and back in time is Jose Duran. Nothing and two to Kendall. He singled in the first, walked and scored in the third, and reached in an error in the fourth. The only error of the game. Another throw goes over to first, and Duran back in time. Fowler comes set, 0-2. Woo, way behind Kendall. That breaking ball just slipped, and now Barry wants a new baseball, and he'll get one. One ball, two strikes. Let's have a look at the Goldeyes this week feature brought to you by Boston Pizza. Try Boston Pizza's all meat wings. This summer, nothing goes better with BP's all meat wings than beer beer. Boston Pizza, here to make you happy. 1-2, runner on the move. Pitch is swung on, and a comebacker to Fowler. Fields that, throws to first, and we will go to the sixth. For the Goldeyes, no runs, one hit, one left. At the end of five, we're tied at 8, TSN 1290.
From the diamond to the driveway, from weekend warrior to world-class pro, local athletes are choosing Manitoba pork for peak performance. Loaded with lean, high-quality protein and essential vitamins and minerals, pork is a powerhouse of nutrition for serious athletes. For a real competitive edge, choose Manitoba pork, fueling today's athletes. Learn more about pork for peak performance at manitobapork.com.
Business owners, do you know where your fleet vehicles are?
I have a good idea.
With a GPS tracking system from Sirius Technologies, you'll know their exact locations.
But I trust my employees.
It's more than that. GPS tracking gives you a bird's eye view of your business with real numbers to measure productivity. Imagine adding one more job a day or cutting idling time by 50%. Sirius Technologies. Data is power. It's time to get serious. For your free one-month trial, visit SiriusTechnologies.ca.
If your business, big or small, has excess waste and recycling piling up, let BFI Canada make your trash our business. Our customized pickup schedules make it easy. With commercial and industrial collection services, BFI Canada can help any business get organized. Want to make your business feel like new? Then call up the blue. Visit BFICanada.com to schedule your pickup date today. BFI Canada, a cleaner community, a greener environment.
Never miss the action with live Goldeyes coverage on TSN 1290. Now, back to the voice of the Goldeyes, here's Paul Edmonds.
Well, we go to the sixth inning. Joe Anthonson, Johnny Kaplan, Corey Morales, 9-1-2 in the order for Sioux Falls. We are tied at 8, and Kaohi Downing works into his fourth inning. And the right-hander will work from the stretch. Atkinson, 1-for-2 tonight, will step in from the left side. A wild one in downtown. And Downing will come set, first pitch. Swung on and sent down the left field line. Look out into the seats. Strike one. Some finals today from the majors. Toronto beat Detroit for their third straight win, 5-1. Seattle over Kansas City, 4-3. Downing comes set. The 0-1 to Ampinson. Swung on and fell back in behind the Goldeyes dugout into the seats for a souvenir. Strike two. Yeah, again, Goldeyes this week brought to you by Boston Pizza. Try Boston Pizza's all-meat wings. This summer, nothing goes better with BP's all-meat wings than all beer beer. Boston Pizza, here to make you happy. Now the Goldeyes wrap up this homestand tomorrow, 1:30 against Sioux Falls. The 0-2, fastball, swung on, fouled back into the sweets and back down below. Nice catch by a fan with one hand. How you doing? And tomorrow, Todd Privett versus Mitchell Clay. Couple of left-handers will be on the air at noon, 55 with 40. Take your calls, emails, texts, tweets. The pitch is down and away, and it got away from. Allen goes back to the screen. One ball, two strikes. Just trying to think. I think we've covered all forms of possible communication to get a question or comment into Rick. Ah, yeah, that's right. The Campbell soup cans and the string. One, two. Breaking ball. I guess missed low, and Luis Alen popped up, ready to go around the horn. Didn't get it from home plate umpire Mike Riggers. Two balls and two strikes. And Rick Forney doing some barking at the home plate umpire, and you don't see that very often. Yeah, I think home plate umpire Mike Riggers might have missed that one there. If Rick's barking, two balls and two strikes, and the pitch. Swing and a miss, and he got him on strike with a high fastball. 91 on the gun from Kaohi right there. And it starts this sixth inning with a strikeout. Downing has a couple of those tonight. Hi to Downing's parents. Tuning in from Honolulu, where it's about 6 hours different. So you're at about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Probably a wonderful 85 degrees on the islands. First pitch to Johnny Kaplan showed bunt. Ran out of the box, pulled back, didn't break the plane to the plate. The pitch missed outside, ball one. Had an opportunity to meet Kaohi's parents. They were here for that 12-game homestand. Brought me a Downing surf shirt. One ball, no strikes to Kaplan, who's 0 for 3 tonight. The pitch. Right down the chute for a strike. 1-1. One ball, one strike. Downing to his belt. And the pitch. Slider swung on and fouled back. 1-2. Now the Goldeyes will get some people up in the bullpen, a right-hander now. Yeah, you got to think that Downing's just about finished for the night. So be his longest appearance. He's at 3 1/3 at this point. 1-2. Swung on, bounce left side. Foul. And Kaplan will stay alive at a ball and two strikes. For Downing, he went 3 innings at one point. And that was July the 1st in Wichita. He's at 3 1/3. Breaking ball swung on and missed. Correction. 3 2/3. Second strikeout in the inning. Great curveball. Third strikeout of the night for Kaohi. So yeah, 3 2/3, his longest outing of the season right now. For Downing. And here's Corey Morales, who's 1 for 3. A strikeout, a two-run double, a run scored, and a flyout to right. Downing comes set. First pitch. Breaking ball in there for a strike. Nothing in one to Kaohi. The pitch. Swung on, that's lifted out toward right, coming hard, Mazzola, and he makes a running catch on the way in, leaning forward, down by his knees, and he'll trot all the way into the Goldeyes dugout. That is it, the top of the sixth here for Sioux Falls. They go 1-2-3, that should be it for Kaohi. Downing, we'll see if he gets a handshake from his pitching coach, and indeed he does. A quality outing for Kaohi. 4 innings, and the Goldeyes have stormed back to tie it at 8. We'll go to the bottom of the sixth. See if Winnipeg can take the lead for the first time tonight. on TSN 1290.
Commissionaires, Manitoba's premier security solutions provider, will take care of your home security needs the next time you go away on vacation. Commissionaires' team of bonded professionals will check on your home and help satisfy your insurance requirements. They do interior and exterior patrols and make your home look lived in. Visit their website at commissionaires.mb.ca for more information about their house watch service. Commissionaires, trusted every day, everywhere.
Who do your Winnipeg Goldeyes trust to keep them in the game with state-of-the-art chiropractic care? ChiroCare Health Center. And if the professionals at ChiroCare Health Center can keep highly tuned athletes going strong for over 100 games a season, imagine what they could do for you. To meet the chiropractic team trusted by your Winnipeg Goldeyes, visit ChiroCareHealth.com or call 488-CARE. ChiroCare Health Center. Care today for a better tomorrow.
I've been drinking Coca-Cola since I was 13. My mom, she packed one with my lunch every day. Been drinking it ever since. Until yesterday, that is. I tried a Pepsi at the Ultimate Taste Challenge. Turns out I like Pepsi. Who knows what else I've been wrong about? Heck, I might like that gangster rap.
You'd be surprised who prefers the taste of Pepsi.
Ooh, that sounds good.
Go to Pepsi Canada on Facebook to find out where you can take the Ultimate Taste Challenge.
Well, we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. My name is Paul Edmonds. Glad to have you along tonight. We are tied at 8. Didn't look very good for Winnipeg. Early on, they were down by 7, 8-1. First pitch to Roberson from Fowler's, a breaking ball that's low. Ball one. Roberson, 2-for-3, 2 runs scored. Yeah, it was a 7-run lead for the Pheasants. Yeah, the Goldeyes were reeling the 1-0 in there for a strike, and it's 1-1. It's Roberson, Weber, and DeCaster, 2-3-4, against the right-hander from Atlanta, Georgia, 36-year-old Barry Fowler. The 1-1. Breaking ball, swung on, hit down the right field line. That is going to get down. It's going to go to the corner. Over to pick it up is Ridge Carpenter. He's going to fire to second, trying for second, and sliding in safely is Roberson with a leadoff double. Third hit of the night for Robo. And the Goldeyes 13th in the ball game. And here's Jon Weber. And Winnipeg will indeed have a chance to take their first lead of the night. Don't forget, Goldeyes this week for Boston Pizza. Wrap it up tomorrow, this series in Homestead. And then they go down to Kansas City and Sioux City for 3-3, starting on Tuesday night. We'll have all the action for you here on TSN 1290. Every single pitch. And now they're going to kick Schrenel to Caster back toward the on-deck circle as he was just a little bit forward of it toward home plate and on the grass. So a leadoff double here for Roberson and Weber. 1-for-3 tonight, a 2-run double. First pitch swung on and filleted foul down the left field line and into the seats. Strike one. Weber drove in his 32nd and 33rd tonight. Runs, 23 hits on the board for the two teams combined. Fowler will come set. Back gap in right center. The pitch. Curve. Missed outside. 1-1. Yeah, they're playing Weber to go the other way. At least Bolden is kind of straight up and down and left, but Kaplan is shading toward left center for Weber to go the other way. 1-1. Breaking ball. Chopped out toward third. Backhanded pickup there by Nicolas. And he looks the runner back and then throws it away at first. And rounding third now and coming in to score the go-ahead run is Roberson. On the error by Cesar Nicolas. Made a great move to his right backhanded pickup. He looked Roberson back to second and then airmailed it past first. Second error of the night to the third baseman for Sioux Falls, and the Goldeyes lead it 9-8. No RBI. Roberson scores his third run of the night. And here's Schrenel to Caster with nobody out. Two errors this evening for Sioux Falls. And both charged to the third baseman. And Fowler comes set. First pitch to DeCaster is on the inside edge and a little bit low, though. Ball one. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday in Kansas City. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, next weekend, Sioux City. The 1-0 swung on and chopper foul off the instep and right back down the box and rolled out toward third base, but a foul ball, 1-1. It'll be the first and only trip for Winnipeg to Kansas City this year. It will be the second and final trip to Sioux City for the Goldeyes this season. Goldeyes will not see Kansas City here in Winnipeg. Just one series between the T-Bones and the Goldeyes, and it's down in Kansas. 1-1 to DeCaster. Fowler comes set. The pitch. Swung on. Chopper out towards short. Morales to second for one. And down to one for two. In time. So it goes 6-4-3 in a double play here. And now the batter with two away will be Luis Alen. Who hit a home run to tie it two innings ago. His fourth home run of the year. Nine-8, the Goldeyes lead it. We're in the bottom of six. First pitch from Fowler is right down the middle for a strike. Nothing and one to Luis Alen. And the 0-1. Breaking ball, swung on, bounced out toward third. Up with it, Nicolas shuffles and throws right on the money to first. And that is it for Winnipeg in the bottom of six. They got a run, a hit, one error that was costly. Nobody left. We'll go to the seventh. 9-8 in favor of Winnipeg. Their first lead of the night through six. TSN 1290.
Welcome to Rogers Tech Talk. Sarah's on the line.
I want a cool new phone, but I have a fear of commitment.
Well, now with Rogers FlexTab, you can get your dream phone, like an HTC One X, on your terms with a low upfront payment.
That's great.
And you could be free of your FlexTab agreement at any time just by paying the remaining balance for the phone.
So I could pay it off in a couple of months.
Sure.
Or next year.
No need to commit. Introducing FlexTab from Rogers. Conditions apply.
Yours today at your local Rogers store, the official wireless provider to the Winnipeg Goldeyes.
Most of us lead busy lives. That's why hiring a trained real estate professional, a realtor, is the way to go when buying or selling a home. A realtor knows the local market and the process involved to help you achieve a successful outcome in the most important financial transaction of your life. Pick up a free copy of the Winnipeg Real Estate News and see their mobile-friendly website to access the public's number one portal to all the current MLS listings.
The Winnipeg Real Estate News.com.
Recycle everywhere.
It's a swing, and he popped it up. Has he got it?
The ball was caught, but not by a glove, Mike. Looks like it landed inside a Recycle Everywhere bin. I'd recognize that little blue bird anywhere.
They're everywhere these days.
Beverage container recycling is expanding in Manitoba. Look for Recycle Everywhere bins at Shaw Stadium and other public places. Visit us at recycleeverywhere.ca.
Recycle
You're listening to Winnipeg Goldeyes Baseball, live on TSN 1290. Brought to you in part by Sirius Technologies. Let's get back to the action with Paul Edmonds.
Well, we're going to go to the seventh inning, and Winnipeg leads it 9-8. New pitcher for Winnipeg will be Craig James. That's it for Kaohi Downing, who stands as the pitcher of record on a winning side. Four innings, no hits, no runs, no walks, three strikeouts, and he hit a batter. And the pitching change is brought to you by Johnson Waste Management, 452-0909. So Craig James into the contest, and he'll face Bolden, Nicolas, and Lawhorn. as we move to the seventh. And James will come set, the right-hander out of Miami. First pitch, right down Broadway for a strike. Oh. Well, what did we tell you about that lead that Saskatchewan had over Hamilton tonight in the CFL? The 0-1, swing and a miss, and it's nothing and two to Jared Bolden, who's 1-3 tonight. Well, let's just say this. Hamilton came back, beat Saskatchewan tonight, 35-34. And Calgary, BC, just underway in the Canadian Football League tonight. 0-2 is in the dirt. One ball, two strikes. Fargo leads the Gary Social Railcats in Indiana tonight, 4-1. That's in the eighth. Bottom three, Grand Prairie ahead of Kansas City, 3-0. Lincoln, Sioux City tied at 1 in the fourth. St. Paul's opened up a 4-0 lead on Quebec in the fourth. Pitches low, 2-2. Wichita leads Laredo, 1-0 in the second. And El Paso and Amarillo just underway on the Manitoba Blue Cross out-of-town scoreboard. 2-2 here to Bolden. And the pitch. Breaking ball swung on, hit out to left field. Kyle Day is there, and an easy track, just a couple of steps back, and he reached up and pulled that in for the first out. One down for Cesar Nicolas. We're in the seventh, one away, 9-8 Winnipeg in front. Nicolas stands in from the right-hand side. He's hit a homer tonight. First pitch. Low and inside, ball one. Craig James. Decent-sized guy, a right-handed pitcher. As he works from the stretch, 6-1, 175, the pitch is in there for a strike, and it's 1-1, 29 years old. And for Craig James, his 26th appearance, he's 2-0 with a 4.10 earned run average. 26 and one-third innings, 29 hits, 12 earned runs, 14 walks, 17 strikeouts, opposition batting 276 against him. 1-1 outside, two balls and one strike. Cesar Nicolas a homer off Rich Hawkins back in the second, and he's bounced out to short twice since then. Two balls, one strike. And James comes set, the pitch. Outside, 3-1. Three and one to Cesar Nicolas. And a pitch is low, ball four. So he walked him, a one-out free pass. First walk of the night issued by Goldeyes pitching. And now Trevor Lawhorn, 1-for-3 tonight. A double, a flyout, and a lineout. Goldeyes have a left-hander in Zach Baldwin throwing to the bullpen. 9-8, Winnipeg in front. We're in the seventh. First pitch. A little bit low, ball one. Cesar Nicolas is not really a threat to steal. He's 1-for-2 on the base paths. Being held on by Sherundel DeCaster. James will come set. And the pitch on the inside edge for a strike. 1-1. Craig's last appearance was against Quebec on Tuesday night. Two innings, one hit, one run. The 1-1 is low, 2-1. Craig's given up an earned run in each of his last three appearances, but he's worked five innings. Two innings the other night, an inning in his last appearance before that, and two before that. The pitch swung on and lifted out toward right. Coming hard, Mazzola, and he'll have to take that on a hop. So a walk and a hit, and now Jake Taylor will step up with two on and one away. And Taylor, a right-handed batter. And now they're going to get Griffin Bailey up in the bullpen as well. And Jake Taylor, the batter. So Bill Pulsifer giving it the old Dragon Griffin look there to get Griffin Bailey up and throwing. First pitch, swung on and missed for strike one. Jake Taylor tonight, 2-for-3. A single and a run scored in the second, an RBI double and he scored in the third, and then grounded out right side to Bryce Kendall in the fifth. Nothing and one to the DH tonight. Two on, one down, the 0-1. Swing and a miss on that slider, and it's nothing and two. Nothing and two to Jake Taylor. Goldie trying to get some people moving here. There you go. James will come set. The 0-2 slider. Cold third strike on the outside corner, and Taylor will go down looking. And Jake Taylor not very happy, but James picks up a strikeout. The Goldeyes have fanned six tonight. And with Rich Carpenter due up and a left-handed bat at that, you're going to see Zach Baldwin come into the baseball game. So Rick Forney comes out, takes the ball from Craig James' hand, and Zach Baldwin will trot in when we trot back in 70. On the call of the bullpen, two out, two on, 9-8 Winnipeg in the seventh, TSN 1290.
Sports fans, TSN 1290 and TSN1290.ca have your day planned for you. It begins with breakfast and a ride to work with a big show with Jay and Westwood.
Minus is a misleading statistic.
How the hell is that, Jay? How can you win a game if you're minus?
Then there's coffee with the herd.
I got news for you. Andrew Luck is better than 10 quarterbacks in the NFL today.
And an afternoon with Jim Rome.
When did it stop being interesting?
Then we'll take you home with Hostler and Lawless.
I think pound for pound, I think we're the best fans in the league. What do you guys think?
Well, I'll tell you what. I get the exact same feeling as you're talking about. We're competing on a major, major landscape against all these other places. I think it's a great story. And the fans of the Jets, you bet. They're right up there with anyone else.
Mornings, afternoons, and all day long. It's TSN 1290 and TSN1290.ca. All sports.
Score!
All the time.
Well, we're in the seventh inning with two away and two on. 9-8, Winnipeg leads at Sioux Falls threatening. Rich Carpenter due up, and Zach Baldwin will be the fourth pitcher of the night for the Goldeyes as they reach a little deeper into their bullpen. For Craig James, two-thirds of an inning, one hit, responsible for two, a walk, a strikeout. And this pitching change brought to you by Johnson Waste Management, 452-0909, as Baldwin will come in. And Zach will go lefty-lefty with Rich Carpenter here in the seventh. Baldwin's given up one earned run in his last 10 appearances, and that was an earned run in Sioux Falls he should have never got tagged with. First pitch, breaking ball, swung on and missed for strike one. But some confused scoring led to it. And he and Dexter on the same weekend got an earned run added on to their earned run average that they were not deserving of having applied. The 0-1 breaking ball swung on, foul back into the mitt of Luis Alen. Nothing at two to Carpenter. For Baldwin, he makes his 26th appearance, 1-1 with a 6.32 ERA. Alen sets up outside, and the pitch. Fastball is just off the table, 1-2. Zach, 15 2/3 innings, 19 hits, 11 earned runs, 8 walks, 5 strikeouts, and the opposition hitting .306 against him. 1-2, the pitch. Breaking ball is outside. Nice block again by Alen. And it's going to hold Cesar Nicolas at second base. Nicolas at second. Lawhorn at first. 9-8 Winnipeg. We're in the seventh. 2-2 to Rich Carpenter, who's 2-for-2 tonight and was hit by a pitch. Lefty-lefty here. Baldwin comes set. 2-2. Just missed inside with that breaking ball. 3-2. Alcantara is standing on deck, and if Baldwin loses Carpenter, you'll probably see Griffin Bailey face Quintana. A full count. The payoff. Breaking ball swung on, hit down the first baseline, but foul. 3 balls, 2 strikes. And Ridge will step back in. Ridge Carpenter from Honolulu, Hawaii as well. 6'2", 190. Born in 1989. 23 years old. The 3-2. Breaking ball swung on. Bang right back up the middle for a base hit. They're going to wave it. Nicolas up with the ball is going to be Roberson. And we are tied at 9. An RBI single by Rich Carpenter. And charge that run to Craig James. And here comes Rick Forney out to get Zach Baldwin. And Alcantara will be the batter with two away. So a real good piece of hitting by the former Goldeye and Carpenter. And we're tied at 9. As he goes back through the box for an RBI single. And now we're going to see Griffin Bailey come in. We'll step aside for 70. Another pitching change here in the seventh on TSN 1290.
For football.
One of the best trades ever in the history of the CFL, arguably, to get Doug Brown here for basically a box of tape.
For hockey.
The first four guys in the NHL draft most years are can't miss.
Nothing but sports.
You lead the league in anonymous quotes. You also lead the league in dysfunction.
When sports is your passion.
There's an emotion in the city, and it permeates the dressing room and the players. They all feel it.
Turn to the station that's even crazier about sports than you are.
I want to be like the Road Warriors. They had the football pads with the spikes coming out and then all the face paint and stuff.
As long as you wear tight shorts, I'm in.
I heard that about you.
Spiky shoulder pads and tight shorts.
I think you still got the panties somewhere around here, Troy, if you want to slip into something a little more comfortable. Troy really is a sensitive guy. I want spikes and shoulder pads and, like, mean-looking face paint. Troy wants tights.
Well, almost as crazy. TSN 1290. All sports, all the time.
Well, one in the seventh inning, and Sioux Falls is tied it at 9. And Alcantara is going to face Griffin Bailey. And the fifth pitcher of the night for the Goldeyes. Baldwin, one batter, a hit. Gives up an inherited run. He's responsible for one. No walks, no strikeouts. Pitching change brought to you by Johnson Waste Management, 452-0909. And Griffin Bailey, a right-hander, will face Alcantara. Second appearance for Griffin Bailey. He joined the team and pitched July 26th against Quebec. 2 innings, 2 hits, no runs. And Griffin from Lexington, Kentucky. 27 years old, 6'5", 220. On this pitching change for Johnson Waste Management. Alcantara is 1-for-3 tonight. First pitch from Bailey. Swung on, line to the gap in right center. That's going to drop, and Sioux Falls is going to take the lead. Around third coming in to score is Lawhorn. First pitch swinging is Alcantana on an RBI single. And it's now 10-9 for the Pheasants. Well, you can close the book now on Craig James. Both those runs are charged to him. And here's Joe Anthonson. Well, we've seen a dichotomy of bullpen work tonight. Real good on Downing's end of things, and then not so good the last three guys here. And Joe Anthonson steps in from the left side. First pitch is inside, ball one. So Sioux Falls has scored twice in the seventh. They lead it 10-9. By the way, I saw that St. Paul picked up Nick Carr today. The 1-0. Swung on, chopper, right side, foul. They have two Cars, Kyle and Nick. Neither are related. Well, they're not related to each other. But Nick Carr is now a St. Paul Saint. One ball, one strike. And the pitch. Inside, 2-1. Griffin Bailey, his second appearance of the Goldeye. Right-hander has pitched in Fargo and Grand Prairie. Two balls, one strike. And the pitch. Outside, 3-1. Joe Anthonson, an RBI single in the second, then a couple of strikeouts since then. Three balls and a strike. Runners on the corners and two away. Two in for Sioux Falls. They lead it by one, the 3-1. Swung on, and that is lined over short into left center for a base hit. And now it's an 11-9 lead as Anthonson has an RBI single. That is three straight RBI singles for Sioux Falls. And he could charge that run to Zach Baldwin. As he gives up a run that's earned here. And now back to the top of the order in Johnny Kaplan. So a two-run lead and three runs in this inning for Sioux Falls. First pitch, breaking ball in there for a strike. Well, you wonder if that's deflating. You've come all the way back from a seven-run deficit to take a one-run lead. And I know the score of the winning run, or the go-ahead run, excuse me, not the winning run, but the go-ahead run, thanks to an error. Another pitch is swung on and lined to right field. That's going to be picked up by Mazzola. He's going to fire it toward home, and everybody stays put. So Johnny Kaplan now has a base hit. No runs will score on that. Quintana will stay in third. Anthony in second, and all of a sudden the Goldeyes can't get anybody out. And here we are with Corey Morales stepping up. And Morales will be the ninth man to hit in the inning, and here comes Bill Pulsifer out to have a chat. This one has been ugly tonight. And while it's been exciting because the Goldeyes have come back, the pitching has not been very good, with the exception of Kaohi Downing. And now a little chat here between Bill Pulsifer and the battery. Three runs have scored for Sioux Falls. They lead it 11-9, and the bases are loaded with two away. They've done all of this with two outs. And now Corey Morales, the battery, is 1-for-4 tonight. And the Goldeyes will get right-hander Dexter Carter up in the bullpen to start throwing. Hits now for Sioux Falls. They're out hitting Winnipeg 15-9. 15-13, excuse me. Pitch is swung on, bounced out toward third, but it's foul. Out hitting Winnipeg 15-13 and leading 11-9. For you Boston Red Sox fans, they beat the Yankees today. 11-6. They had a rain delay to start at Yankee Stadium. Nothing in, one to Morales. Bases loaded, the pitch is low. Throw down to second, or actually down to first. He is not in time. Kaplan got back in time on that throw to first. Snap throw by Allen. One ball, one strike. 1-1 to Morales. One ball, one strike. And the pitch. Breaking ball is low, 2-1. Mari Morales batting .311. He had a two-run double in that six-run second inning. The 2-1. Swung on, ground ball back up the middle for a base hit. One runs in to score. And coming around second is going to be around third, actually, is Anthonson. He'll be the second run to score. And it's 13-9 here. A two-run single by Corey Morales. So Quintana scores, Anthonson scores from second. It's a five-run inning for Sioux Falls. And here's Jared Bolden, who started it by flying out to left. And a four-run lead again for the Pheasants. First pitch, swung on, ground ball right side. Up with it, Kendall over to first. Inning over. Well, Sioux Falls scores five again. And they do so on six hits, no errors, and they leave two. We'll go to the bottom of the seventh inning. Stretch time in my hometown. We invite you wherever you are to get up and do the same with us. It is 13-9 for the Pheasants on TSN 12-9.
What makes Tavern United Manitoba's number one sports pub? Service second to none. Food that's right on point. And value that's big league all the way. And this summer, during Tavern United's Your Team, Your Tickets promotion, win weekly prizes and qualify to win season tickets to your Winnipeg Goldeyes, Blue Bombers, and of course, the Jets. So get your friends together for some frothy fun, fabulous food, and guaranteed good times at your new World Sports Pub, Tavern United.
We keep old files because they're out of sight and out of mind, or because we think we have to. But someday, those old files could bite us if they get in the wrong hands. Isn't it time you let bygones be bygones? Have Protect Document Destruction's mobile service professionally shred your files wherever they are to rid yourself of those ticking time bombs. Protect Document Destruction, 975-0505, a division of Johnson Waste Management.
Free Jive Interactive Media is online, on site, and on the street. Grab the new online version of the Free Jive Weekly at freejivewinnipeg.com or pick it up at one of our 200 local restaurant locations. Find us at local events and keep a lookout for the Free Jive Cruiser around the city. And make sure to visit freejivewinnipeg.com to keep updated on all of our weekly contests and giveaways. Free Jive Interactive Media, online, on site, on the street.
Well, we go to the bottom of the seventh, and the Goldeyes have some work to do here. They trail by four again. It's 13-9, a five-run seventh for Sioux Falls, and all of it coming with two outs. And the top half of this inning, after Winnipeg came all the way back from an 8-1 deficit to lead 9-8, now they trail 13-9. Barry Fowler works into his fourth inning. Here's Kyle Day, 1-for-3 tonight. First pitch is right down the middle for a strike. Now let's have a look at the answer and pass along our winner's name here on Trivia in the bottom of seven. Trivia contest question brought to you by Blas Louis Riel, Sweet Hotel in downtown Winnipeg. The 0-1 swung on, hit down the first baseline, foul. Blas Louis Riel specializing in spacious executive suites. Day one for three tonight. Pitch is inside, 2-2. The question tonight was this. Aside from Chris Roberson, who is the only other player to play center field for the Goldeyes this season? The 1-2. Inside, 2-2. Well, congratulations to Pat Bobko of Dugald, Manitoba, who's actually in Section E tonight. Pat knew the answer to be Ridge Carpenter. Pitch is swung on, bounce right side. Up with it, Anthonson. Over to first, one away. Yeah, Ridge Carpenter, who now plays for Sioux Falls, is the only other Goldeye to start or play in center field this year. And that was back on July the 10th, game 50. And here's Josh Mazzola. So, Pat, congratulations. The answer, Ridge Carpenter, and Pat picks up a pair of Goldeye tickets. First pitch is in there for a strike to a future home game and is also eligible to win the grand prize of a weekend stay at the Place Louis at the end of the season. Mazzola 2-for-3 tonight, a couple of doubles. And the 0-1 is outside, one ball, one strike. So the answer, Ridge Carpenter. Winner is Pat Bobko, who's at the game tonight. One ball, one strike. And the pitch swung on. That's lined out to left. And Bolden to his right will make a nice running catch for the second out. Call that a liner to left. Two away for Amos Ramon. And Amos 1-for-2 with a sacrifice fly. Well, Barry Fowler's done a real good job here for Steve Shirley tonight. First pitch is low, ball one. One ball, no strikes. And the 1-0. Swung on, and that is hit sharply out towards second to his right. Backhanded pickup and a high hop by Anthonson, and he'll throw to first to get Amos. And 1-2-3 down the goal to Goldeyes in the seventh. We'll go to the eighth. 13-9 Sioux Falls, TSN 1290.
Grill Therapy is on now at Boston Pizza, a way to relax through the healing powers of grilled meat. Kevin and his wife just had octuplets. That's 8 babies.
8 babies. You'd think you would have seen that on the ultrasound. He said he was a doctor. But this backyard burger made with 100% Canadian beef has almost made me forget that when I get home, I have to feed Samantha, Tanya, Eugene, little Jesus, so funny, Gerald.
Boston
Stanley,
Pizza, Catherine, here to make you happy. Visit Boston Pizza for details while quantities last.
All your bases covered? With Manitoba Blue Cross, you do. They provide peace of mind for you and your family, no matter what the situation. Planning on taking a little family trip? Make sure to get travel coverage from Blue Cross. Looking for more benefits for your employees? Look no further than Blue Cross. They also handle individual life insurance. It's a real triple play.
Contact your insurance broker or visit nb.bluecross.ca.
Manitoba Blue Cross, color of caring.
Milwaukee Tools continue to revolutionize the cordless power tool industry with the introduction of M18 Fuel, an exclusive line of extreme performance cordless power tools designed, engineered, and built by Milwaukee to deliver unmatched productivity. When you use an M18 tool with the Fuel name, you know you've invested in the most advanced cordless technology available. Simply put, Fuel delivers unmatched power, runtime, and durability on the job site. Fuel, built for the industrial industry.
You're listening to Goldeyes Baseball Live on TSN 1290. Brought to you in part by Avalon and the Gulf Dome.
Well, that's it for Griffin Bailey tonight. One third of an inning, four hits, two runs, both third. No walks, no strikeouts, and he gives way to Dexter Carter, who becomes the sixth pitcher for Winnipeg tonight. We move to the eighth. 13-9 Sioux Falls. And the pitching change brought to you by Johnson Waste Management, 452-0909. And so Dexter Carter comes in. Yeah, it has been a wild game here tonight. The Goldeyes were down 8-1 at one point, scored 8 unanswered to take a 9-8 lead, then gave up 5 last inning and trail here 13-9. 22 runs on the board and 29 hits. Both errors belong to Sioux Falls. And here's Cesar Nicolas to face Dexter Carter. And Dexter makes his 29th appearance. He's 1-2 with a 3.41 earned run average. First pitch. Oh, way inside, and it knocked Nicolas down, and I don't think it hit him, though. Ball one. Carter, 31 2/3 innings, 36 hits. 12 earned runs, 16 walks, 36 strikeouts. And the opposition batting .288 against him. The 1-0. Swung on, chopper, left side, foul. One ball, one strike. We're on the top of the eighth inning. Nicolas tonight, 1-for-3. His one hit was a home run that came way back to open the scoring in the second, and he's also walked and scored. Sioux Falls has scored 11 runs in 2 innings, 6 in the second, 5 in the seventh. Carter comes set, 1-1. Half a swing, did he go? The appeal, and yes, at first base, says Mike O'Leary. And the count, 1-2. Let's have a look at trades and transactions here in this eighth inning for the Animal Hospital Manitoba. We are a full-service veterinary hospital that also provides behavioral and nutritional counseling. The Animal Hospital Manitoba, the 1-2. Oh, way inside, and Nicolas just got hit. We treat your pets as if they were our own. So, the Goldeyes plunked their second pheasant here tonight. Downing hit Carpenter. And now, Carter hits Nicolas with a curveball. And here's Trevor Lawhorn, 2-for-4. Well, Gary and Lincoln were involved in a trade today. First pitch, low, ball one. Gary traded left-handed pitcher David Kwiatkowski and outfielder Matt Forgach to Lincoln in exchange for outfielder Asif Shah and right-handed pitcher, and the bunt is popped out in front of the mound, caught by Dexter Carter. Now he throws to first, not in time. Good athletic play by Dexter. A bunt by Lawhorn popped up in front of the mound, and Dexter came off the front and dove and caught it. And then from his knees had the presence of mind to try to double off Nicolas over at first, but it wasn't in time. So the rare pop to one, and there's one down for Jake Taylor. Sioux Falls may be trying to get a runner into scoring position and take the grand slam out of play. And Jake Taylor, the batter, he's 2-for-4. Again, Gary traded left-handed pitcher David Kwiatkowski and outfielder Matt Forgach to Lincoln in exchange for outfielder Asif Shah. Pitch is swung on and lifted out toward left. Kyle Day is going to take that on a hop as it drops down for Taylor's third hit of the night. And there's two on and one down for Ridge Carpenter. Lincoln also gets right-handed pitcher Alberto Rolon, who's been traded twice now. So Asif Shah and Alberto Rolon go to Gary in exchange for outfielder Matt Forgach and left-handed pitcher David Kwiatkowski. First pitch is low and inside, ball one. Carpenter's had a good night. He's 3-for-3, 2 RBI, a run scored, and he's been hit by a pitch. The 1-0 is inside, 2-0. Kansas City traded right-handed pitcher Jake Wiley to New Jersey, the Can-Am League, in exchange for futures. And Lincoln, in a separate move, other than that trade with Gary today, the 2-0 swung on, fouled away, 2-1. Signed right-handed pitcher Brandon Sinnery and placed right-handed pitcher Tyson Bove on the disabled list. That's it for trades and transactions. Around the American Association today and tonight. But 2-1. Swung on, fell back to the screen, 2-2. For the Animal Hospital of Manitoba, we treat your pets as if they were our own. Two balls and two strikes to Rich Carpenter. Two and two. And the pitch swung on, and that has popped up into Ward center field and back, and now in is going to be Roberson. He makes the catch. The throw will go to third, and it won't be in time. Both runners will tag on that Rich Carpenter fly ball to center field. So Nicolas goes second to third, and Taylor first to second, and Al Quintana the batter. 13-9 in favor.
Now
that,
the catcher number 17, Al Quintana.
Of Sioux Falls. And no activity in that bullpen for the Pheasants, so it tells me that Barry Fowler is going to come out for another inning. Alcantara, 2-for-4 tonight. Couple RBI, first pitch. Breaking ball, swung on and missed for strike one. Nothing and one. Carter comes set, righty-righty here, the pitch. Curve missed inside off the glove of Allen. Coming down from third is Nicolas. He'll score the 14th run for Sioux Falls, and they're up by five. And that'll be on a pass ball. Fourteen to nine is the score. Alcantara with a count of one ball, one strike on him. One and one. The pitch swung on. That's lined to right center. That's going to drop for a base hit. And in to score is going to be Jake Taylor. Heading for second is Quintana, and he will get there safely with an RBI double. Two more runs for Sioux Falls. They lead it 15 to 9. And the Goldeyes bullpen here tonight has been stung. Here's Joe Anthonson. Now a 6-run lead for Sioux Falls, almost back to their largest lead of the night, which was 7. First pitch swung on. That's hit out to left field toward the line. Kyle Day, he'll make the catch, and that's it for the Pheasants here in the 8th inning. They add on two more runs, two more hits, and they leave one. We'll go to the bottom of 8. 15-9, Sioux Falls over Winnipeg, TSN 1290.
A good hit to right field. It's going, going, over the wall.
Hit a home at Cambrian Credit Union. Thanks to the unfee, our members saved over $3 million in the last year. A real team bonus.
In business, you need all aspects of your operation working together.
Still, the decisions you make in one area can impact another. At MNP, we offer a full range of services from accounting, consulting, and tax, so we can help across all aspects of your operation with the resources and industry-specific knowledge that can help your business grow. Think forward. Contact your local MNP office or visit us online at mnp.ca.
Business owners, do you know where your fleet vehicles are?
I have a good idea.
With a GPS tracking system from Sirius Technologies, you'll know their exact locations.
But I trust my employees.
It's more than that. GPS tracking gives you a bird's eye view of your business with real numbers to measure productivity. Imagine adding one more job a day or cutting idling time by 50%. Sirius Technologies. Data is power. It's time to get serious. For your free one-month trial, visit SiriusTechnologies.ca.
While we go to the bottom of the eighth inning, my name is Paul Edmonds, our producer, operator back in the studios, Rob Innes, Dana Robbie helping us out on site. 15-9 Sioux Falls in this playground seesaw battle here tonight. Here's Jose Duran, followed by Bryce Kendall and Chris Roberson. Barry Fowler works into his fifth inning and is the pitcher of record on a winning side. First pitch to Duran is a fastball that's low, ball one. Let's have a look at Inside the Numbers here, and Inside the Numbers brought to you by Recycle Everywhere, making away from home recycling commonplace. To learn more, visit recycleeverywhere.ca, the 1-0. Inside, two balls and no strikes. Sioux Falls has scored 6 runs in the second, 2 in the third, 5 in the seventh, 2 more in the eighth. The 2-0 in there for a strike. Goldeyes have scored in 3 consecutive innings, 1 in the second, 3 in the third, 4 in the fourth, and a singleton in the sixth. But nothing since that single run in the sixth, and they trail here by 6. The pitch swung on, chopper out towards short, running pickup, and a nice one of that by Morales, and he'll throw to first, and the game's other shortstop is retired here for the first out in the bottom of the eighth. And Bryce Kendall to bat. A total of 24 runs have been scored. Sioux Falls with 18 hits, the Goldeyes with 13. 31 hits in total. And the only 2 errors belong to Sioux Falls. First pitch is in there for a strike to Kendall. There's some numbers for you. Now the Goldeyes are looking up at the wrong end of them. Pitch. Low, 1-1. Now Winnipeg down to their final 5 outs here tonight. 1-1. Swung on, ground ball right side. Knocked down by Lawhorn. Picks it up and will feed it to Barry Fowler, covering in front of Kendall for the second out. As the pitcher gets there and advances the Goldeyes runner. 2 away. And we're getting a little bit closer to looking like tomorrow is going to be the rubber match in this series. By the way, the Goldeyes had won 3 straight against Sioux Falls entering this one tonight. And Chris Roberson, 3-for-4, 3 runs scored this evening, steps up and in. First pitch, low and inside, ball one. One ball, one strike. And the 1-0. And there for a strike. And it's 1-1. 2 away in the bottom of 7 here tonight. Or bottom of 8, excuse me. A 1-1 pitch. Swung on, bounced over the mound, back in behind second. Up with it, Morales over to first. Goldeyes go 1-2-3. We'll go to the ninth. A 6-run lead for Sioux Falls on TSN 1290.
When you're stepping up to the plate with a major league appetite, make the big play for the home run special at Chicken Delight. Here's the pitch. 8 pieces of delicious chicken, medium fries and gravy, 2-liter Pepsi, and 2 free Winnipeg Goldeyes ticket vouchers. That's a $40 value for just $26.99. It's a hit!
So don't call tonight.
Tonight, all right!
Call Chicken Delight.
Summer is something to enjoy. But remember, drinking any alcohol and driving don't mix. Drinking and driving puts you and others in danger. Your best bet is a designated driver who has had no alcohol. Enjoy your summer, but whatever you do, don't drink and drive. To keep Manitobans safe behind the wheel, police are increasing enforcement near you. Watch for them. A message from Manitoba Public Insurance.
Thinking forward means challenging your business to grow. It's about making hard decisions today to ensure a better tomorrow. At MNP, we'll help your business think forward by being a partner that understands your business challenges and providing industry-specific thought leaders to help take you to the next level. Think forward. Contact your local MNP office or visit us online at mnp.ca.
Never miss the action with live Goldeyes coverage on TSN 1290. Now, back to the voice of the Goldeyes, here's Paul Edmonds.
Well, we go to the ninth inning, top of the order here for Sioux Falls. They lead it 15-9. And it's Johnny Kaplan, Corey Morales, and Jared Bolden. 1-2-3. And Dexter Carter will work into his second inning. And Carter will come set. First pitch. Swung on, wrapped out toward third. To his left, half a step. Ramon fields that, throws to first. Not in time. And Kaplan beat it out. Infield single. And Kaplan's second hit of the night. And for Sioux Falls, their 19th hit of the evening. Here's Corey Morales, 2-for-5 tonight, 4 RBI. First pitch is bounced out toward third, fielded by Ramon, throws to second. And are they going to force Kaplan there? Yes, they do. So fielder's choice, and there's one away. They get the lead runner of Kaplan, 5-4. And Morales is safe at first base. Here's Jared Bolden, he is 1-for-5 tonight. The 19 hits, by the way, if you're wondering, are the most that the Goldeyes have given up this season. They had twice given up 18 and once 16. And 19 is the season high now for hits allowed. First pitch swung on and missed for strike one. And 15 runs. Pretty good mark here, too. The 0-1 swung on, fouled away, and it's nothing in two. The most runs allowed by the Goldeyes this season, 16. And that was here at home on a Sunday afternoon when Fargo got the best of Winnipeg. So this one has a team high for the most hits allowed and one shy of runs. Pitches outside. 1-2. One ball, two strikes. Carter comes set in the pitch. Fastball swung on, bounced out toward first by a diving DeCaster into right field for a base hit. And we have hit 20. Sioux Falls with 20 hits tonight, leading 15-9 in this ninth inning. And here's Cesar Nicolas. And Nicolas will stand in from the right side. Nicolas has scored three times tonight, and he flat out lines one to right field. First pitch swinging. And it's 21 hits. Now the bases are loaded. Morales stops at third. Bolden stops at second. And here's Trevor Lawhorn. 2 for 5 tonight.
Now
the first baseman,
number
14,
Trevor Long.
21 hits for Sioux Falls. First pitch right down the middle for a strike. Nothing and one for Trevor Lawhorn. One away, and the base is loaded. The pitch is low, 2-1. .15-9, Sioux Falls in front. And the pitch inside, 2-1. Two balls, one strike. And Carter comes set, the 2-1. Swung on, wrapped out toward third, but foul. Two and two. Trevor Lawhorn batting .282. Three hits now in this series. And eight trips. A pheasant at every base. Carter comes set. 2-2. Breaking ball, swung on and missed. Got him on strikes. And for Carter, his first strikeout of the night. And Goldeyes pitching has struck out 7, and here's Jake Taylor. Oh, it's 2 away. We look ahead to the ninth for Winnipeg. Weber, DeCaster, and Allen. First pitch. Breaking ball, swung on and missed for strike one. Jake Taylor's had a fine night tonight. 3 hits, 3 runs scored. He's driven in a run. The 0-1. Breaking ball, swung on and missed. It's nothing at 2. Bases loaded, 2 away. 15-9, Sioux Falls. The 0-2, swung on and fouled back. And a game that saw Sioux Falls go ahead 8-1. Goldeyes then go ahead 9-8. And Sioux Falls come back to go ahead 15-9. Nothing in 2 to Jake Taylor. Carter comes set to his belt. Righty-righty here. The 0-2. Fastball, or actually a breaking ball, is low. And 1 ball and 2 strikes. 21 hits tonight for Sioux Falls. That's a season high allowed by Winnipeg. The 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss, and he got him on strikes. Good breaking ball, and Dexter Carter fends the last 2 he faces. No runs for Sioux Falls. 3 hits in the inning, and they leave them loaded. We'll go to the bottom of 9. Last chance for the Goldeyes. They need 6 to tie, 7 to win it. We'll see if they've got it in them when we return on TSN 1290.
Coaches, your players are great at scoring goals. But when the goal is raising money, it's not always easy to score. And that's where the Winnipeg Free Press can help. We're introducing a unique fundraising promotion available to all Manitoba minor league sports teams. And if you participate, your team has a chance to meet Winnipeg Jets of Vander Kane. For complete program information, go to winnipegfreepress.com/teamkane and find out how your team can get involved.
Peak of the Markets Family Fun Day is Thursday, August 9th from 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. This fundraiser for Variety, the Children's Charity of Manitoba, will include a free potato pancake breakfast from 7 to 10, a free lunch with pork in a bun, potato salad, and coleslaw from 11 to 2. There'll be free pony rides, petting zoo, a giant slide, a jumper, and a lot more. Everything is free with any donation to Variety. Peak of the Markets Family Fun Day, Thursday, August 9th at 1200 King Edward Street. For complete details, visit peakmarket.com.
The Greenwood Inn & Suites invites you to make it your home base for an overnight stay, your next meeting, or social event. You can even make it a home run with all-day dining or Sunday brunch at Dalton's. Enjoy the first-class service and facilities the Greenwood Inn & Suites has to offer. To book your next stay, visit the website at greenwoodwinnipeg.com or call 775-9889. 775-9889. The Greenwood Inn & Suites, putting the friendly in friendly Manitoba.
Well, we go to the bottom of the ninth inning. And Jon Weber to lead it off. Barry Fowler looking to close it down. After coming in, first pitch is swung on and fouled away. Strike one in the fourth. So Fowler works into his sixth inning. Pitch of record on a winning side. 15-9, Sioux Falls. The 0-1. Inside, one ball, one strike. You don't have faith, though, because the Goldeyes have put up multi-runs in innings against Sioux Falls this year. 1-1. Swing and a miss and a change of pace. They put up a 5-run inning twice against Sioux Falls, a 6-run inning, and an 8-run inning. By the way, Fargo beat Gary tonight 9-2 on the Manitoba Blue Cross out of town scoreboard. Pitches high, 2-2. If the Goldeyes do not come back, they will be 5 games back of Fargo for first in the north. And Kansas City is leading Grand Prairie. They could cut the Goldeyes leading the wild card to 2. St. Paul's leading Quebec 4-0 in the 7th. They could be 2.5 back. Pitch is swung on and sent down the right field line, foul. 2-2. Now, when you have a lead and you start to lose, things get tight real quick. Two and two to Weber. He's 1-for-4 tonight. The pitch missed outside. 3-2. This game is now 3 hours and 4 minutes old, as you might expect, with 24 runs on the board and 33 hits. The payoff, swung on, chopper foul, first base side, and Weber will stay alive. Three balls, two strikes to Jon Weber, who struck out, flown out, had a 2-run single, and reached on an error. And Fowler will rock, kick, and fire. Pitch is swung on, sent down the first base line, foul. Good at bat here for Jon Weber. Not giving up the at-bat here. And a full count. And now a new apple request here from Barry Fowler. And he'll get a new baseball. 3 balls, 2 strikes. Now the payoff pitch. Swung on, and that is off somebody in the Goldeyes dugout. Todd Privett just ducking over there. Three balls, two strikes. And the pitch swung on, lifted out toward left, in toward the corner, long run for Bolden, and he will leap, and does he make the catch? Yes, he does. Nice grab by Jared Bolden in left field in the corner. I think it was a fair ball. And there's one away. He doesn't make that catch. It's extra bases for Jon Weber. And here's Sherundel DeCaster. And DeCaster one for four. And the first pitch is in there for a strike. Fifteen to nine, Sioux Falls in front. They've taken control of this game with a five-run seventh and a two-run eighth. 0-1 is outside. One ball, one strike. Goldeyes down to their final two outs here. And the 1-1. Swung on, line to right field for a base hit. And the Goldeyes have their 14th hit of the night. And Luis Alen, the batter, a two-run homer tonight. A single, two-run scored. And Alen will step in from the right side. And the first pitch is on the outside edge for a strike. Nothing in one to Luis Alen. The 0-1 swung on, chopper left side foul. It's nothing in two. If the Goldeyes lose tonight, they will have lost eight of their last 14. And 6 of 7 at home. Nothing in two to Luis Alen. And the pitch swung on, chopper out towards short. To second for one, and down to one for two, and that'll end it. Or was he safe? Yeah, Luis Alen safe. Beat it out on a fielder's choice, and the out of DeCaster goes 6-4. Nice play by Morales to start it. And there's two away for Kyle Day. 15-9 Sioux Falls, and that'll send a few more people home.
Number 28, Kyle Day.
Now the Goldeyes did enough here tonight to win a baseball game with the offense they put up. 9 runs, 14 hits, but on the pitching side tonight, it was a tough night. First pitch swung on, bounced right side, fielded by Anthonson, throws to first, and we have a series that is tied at one as Sioux Falls wins it tonight, 15-9. They end a long six-game losing skid, and they set up the rubber match tomorrow here in downtown Winnipeg. Goldeyes record here at home will drop to 18-15, and they've lost 8 of 14 games here, and they lose tonight 15-9. We'll take a timeout when we come back. The post-game show and the totals up next on TSN 1290.
If you love fishing, you've got to discover the Alumacraft difference. Alumacraft boats simply deliver way more bang for your fishing buck. More models to choose from, more durability, more resale value, more outstanding performance, more of everything you want in a boat that will last. You really can see and feel the difference quality makes. Get the facts at alumacraft.com or give Girton Equipment a call at 1-800-619-0614. Alumacraft. Better built, better ride, better value.
Patient safety is everyone's concern.
Healthcare is a big, complex system, and sometimes things happen that aren't planned. What can you do to make your care safer? Get involved. Discuss your health concerns with your doctor, nurse, and pharmacist. Make a list of your medications and keep it with you. Wash your hands often to reduce the spread of germs. The Manitoba Institute for Patient Safety website has more information on how you can learn to be safe.
This Goldeyes season, Salisbury House on the Esplanade Riel is hitting it right out of the park. With great new taste sensations to get you ready to roar before the game or relive the fun after the final out. With so many great choices, every visit is a new eating adventure. And remember, Sal's is the only place to go for a nip platter, the fan favorite that hits a home run every time. So before or after any Goldeyes game, stroll on over for great food and fun on the Esplanade Riel at Salisbury House. Your house, your food, your way.
Follow the Super Lube Summer Cruiser now through August to see the sights and sounds of Winnipeg this summer with TSN 1290. Get $5 off an oil change from Super Lube, free barbecue sauce from Denny's Whole Hog Barbecue, and enter to win a $5,000 kitchen makeover from Rose Hill Cabinetry. Stop by and see us at awesome summer events in and around Winnipeg. Keep listening to TSN 1290 to hear where the Super Lube Summer Cruiser will be this week.
The 2-1 swung on, line to the gap in left center. That's going to get down and score both runs. In to score is Kendall. On his heels, Roberson. RBI single, Schirundel to Caster. And it's 8-3. Well, that's the big hit Winnipeg needed right there to kind of jumpstart things here. And it did indeed. It sparked the comeback.
Most times winning and losing, but I'm just very uneasy when guys are hurt and then you're asking them to play through. It's not a comfortable feeling for me. And then when you're coming to the park the next day, you're just not sure what you're going to get. But slowly but surely, I think we're slowly getting healthy. I know people are in the lineup, but that doesn't make them healthy. You know what I mean? Unfortunately, we don't have a choice. This is the way we have to play it out. So. Slowly but surely, I think we're heading in the right direction.
And I guess case in point there is you have John play in left field yesterday, and you go back to a DH day with him today. So you're trying to loosen him up, but at the same time, you're trying to protect him a little bit until that ankle's, well, as close to 100% as it's going to be this year.
I don't know how close we're going to get to 100% with John and his ankle. And same thing with the caster. Same thing, that's the obvious with Price, is that's... he's not going to be 100%. So if we can somewhere get to 90, I think we'll be good enough at that point and still be able to run the bases and do the things we need. And defensively, we could be limited with our lack of foot speed at this time, but hopefully that improves as well. But for us, it's, the key is scoring runs in this league, and I've said that many a times. And we need the guys that are healthy that can run to get on base, to have the best month of their life. Because if guys like Kyle or Mazzola gets on base, Amos, Duran, Roberson, if they can play at a high clip, then sometimes we can play through it and still produce enough runs. We just need to make sure the guys that are running well and healthy, that they get on base.
That's a great point, because you do have a running element to this team. We haven't seen a lot of it because of injury, but now maybe we're going to start to see a little more of it because those guys are back in your lineup. Yeah. And if they can get on base through their on-base percentage any way they can, then it gives you another dimension to your offense.
Sure it does. You need to be able to run the bases, especially going first to third on base hits. And if you don't have that ability, it's hard. It's hard to string together three base hits to score a run. And you need to be able to run the bases well to give yourself an honest chance to score with some consistency.
I know the deadline's probably not for another couple of weeks, but I'll ask you right now, are you looking around, or are people inquiring from you, or is there a lot of talk? Do you anticipate any movement? I know Gary made a bit of a move today with Lincoln, but, where do you stand on standing pat or trying to improve?
I'm always calling around and asking questions. It's just a whether or not if somebody's a fit. Obviously, I'm not in a situation where I'm dumping anything. I'm looking to add if there's something that's not going to be a lateral move, I'm just not going to do it just to do it. It has to be something that's going to help my team and not disrupt my clubhouse. So I do that throughout the course of the year. So right now, to be honest with you, I wouldn't expect a lot of people to be making moves because almost everybody's in the hunt still at this point. So I'm sure things will pick up pace a little bit with some clubs over the next 2 weeks, but I don't know where I'll be.
Alan Durratt for them tonight, right-hander.
Yeah, you know, you're going to get some good fastballs to hit with him. He's kind of tough read. So some innings he looks really good, and some innings he kind of loses it. But he threw a nice ball game against us at Sioux Falls, and he competes, he challenges you with his fastball, and that's what everybody likes to see in this league. So hopefully we can get some to hit.
Just back to Rich for a second. He's given you some decent starts. He's taking you through some deep starts, you know, six innings. And if you can get that, I think you'd be pleased with him tonight.
Well, just five is enough for us today. We have enough guys in the bullpen that can close out the last four innings. Just need five good ones. And just if we can get that without him going out there and giving up a three or four spot in one of those innings, then we should be in good shape.
And if you scored early for him, it would be take a little pressure off, wouldn't it?
It certainly helps for any pitcher, but especially true for a rookie pitcher.
Rick Forney, field manager of the Winnipeg Goldeyes Baseball Club on the Winnipeg Insurance pregame show right out of the ballpark. Brought to you by Winnipeg Insurance, proud sponsors of the Winnipeg Goldeyes, helping you protect the things you love. Visit us on the web at winnipeginsurancebrokers.com or call us at 889-2870. Take a timeout. When we come back, we'll have a look at what happened last night in and around the American Association, what's going on tonight, and how the standings impact this one today. The Morning Line is next for Assiniboia Downs.